Chapter 46. The girl was in love. The Gken Gardens had an elegant environment with pavilions, bamboo, and rocks. It was quiet and comfortable. A group of people arrived in front of one of the pavilions. They saw a girl, about 20 years old, come out of the pavilion. She greeted Tang Lan. "Hi, Professor Tang." "Ni Bing, this is Mr. Hua and his disciple." Tang Lan made the introductions. "This is my first disciple, Ni Bing. The younger ones are now cultivating in Donghai Academy." "Don't worry, I won't let Yi Fushan see them." Yi Fushan smiled wryly. His reputation had been ruined by Hua Fengliu. "Mr. Hua," Ni Bing greeted Hua Fengliu. "The place you used to live in has been kept vacant, but it's clean, so you can stay there," Tang Lan told Hua Fengliu. "Thank you." Hua Fengliu nodded. "If you had gratitude, you would not have left me." Tang Lan still resented him because of their past. Hua Fengliu did not refute this. He responded with nothing but silence. "Miss Tang, my professor has been missing you all this time. He told me many times that he had failed someone and he played the Gken every time this memory came back." Yi Fushan spoke for Hua Fengliu. Tang Lan looked at Yi Fushan with suspicion. "Is that true?"
"Of course."
Yi Fushan looked serious. "I did not know who that person was, but today after meeting you, Miss Tang, I totally understand that feeling." Tang Lan looked into the crystal bright eyes of the boy, and she started to believe he was telling the truth. She turned toward Hua Fengliu, and he was shaking his head, sighing. "It's all just in the past." "Okay, you do have some last shreds of a conscience." Tang Lan finally believed him. Yu Sheng was surprised that Yi Fushan was able to help Hua Fengliu gain forgiveness from his old flame. "Ni Bing, go get my Gken," Tang Lan told her. Ni Bing left and soon returned with a Gken in her arms. Hua Fengliu was overcome with emotion. "Thank you for repairing Da Ayu for me. Da Ayu used to be your favorite Gken. Now it's time to return it to you." Ni Bing gave it to Hua Fengliu. Hua Fengliu took the Gken and strummed the strings with his fingers. They heard a unique sound coming out of the Gken, which brought the audience into an empty and secluded world, as if it had magical powers. "Wow, an artifact." Yi Fushan was awed. "Objects enhanced with spells were called artifacts." "Yi Fushan, come here. It belongs to you now." Hua Fengliu handed the Gken over to Yi Fushan. Tang Lan was confused about this. She had realized that Hua Fengliu would give this disciple everything. For the Gken Devil, this Gken was almost as important as his life. Yi Fushan took it carefully with both hands and replied with a smile. "Professor, I will not let you down." "I believe you." Hua Fengliu laughed. He knew Yi Fushan was genuinely talented. He just needed time to hone his power. "What's your plan now?" "Don't think about revenge. I always wanted to destroy his natal spirit because of what he did to you, but he was just too powerful," Tang Lan said. Hua Fengliu knew who she was talking about. It was his longtime nemesis, the art saint. "I did not come here for revenge. I brought Yi Fushan here to attend Donghai Academy. However, since the spring term admission test has ended, I'm afraid that he will have to wait until next year." "You've stayed in this city all these years. Do you know if there is anything I can do to get Yi Fushan into that academy?" Hua Fengliu asked Tang Lan. Tang Lan shook her head and answered, "Unless someone of high authority at the academy asked for him personally." Hua Fengliu frowned, looking like he was thinking hard. "Professor, why do I have to attend Donghai Academy?" Yi Fushan asked. "In the city of Qingzhou, Qingzhou Academy is a sacred place, and the official students of Qingzhou Academy have a high social status in the city. Most of the important people of that city graduated from that academy. Even the lord of the city is supposed to show respect to Qingzhou Academy." Hua Fengliu answered his question. "It's the same for Donghai Academy. However, Donghai Academy is even more remarkable. Donghai Academy is not the only academy in this city, but it is the oldest one, founded more than 300 years ago, when this continent was in severe conflict. The initial founding of this academy was intended to serve the major families in this city, and this purpose has not changed." "So, you mean Donghai Academy is more than just a school?" Yi Fushan asked curiously. "Correct. Donghai Academy is far more powerful and complex than you'd think. If you attend Donghai Academy, your safety will be better ensured," Hua Fengliu explained. Yi Fushan nodded. realizing that Hua Fengliu had a more significant plan in mind. Otherwise, they would not have come here. I met your professor at Donghai Academy. Tang Lan sounded sad, as if some past memory had just popped into her mind. In fact, we were about your age. Hua Fengliu was smiling. What a beautiful time it was. I was willing to devote my most precious youth to you, but soon after you met her, Tang Lan kept speaking, I made a mistake. Hua Fengliu was embarrassed. You feel guilty? Tang Lan was mad, and she being sarcastic with Hua Fengliu, to be honest, I was not as beautiful as that girl, but as far as talents and power, I was considered to be the top of my class. Why did I devote myself to the wrong man? I'm tired, Yi Fushan. Help me go back to my room. Hua Fengliu tried to close his eyes. Yes, Yi Fushan responded. He lifted Hua Fengliu onto his back and carried him to his room. Tang Lan still looked like she was mad at what had happened in the past, but since Hua Fengliu had lost his ability to walk, she began to sympathize and warm up to him. Yi Fushan carried Hua Fengliu into the room and asked, Professor, Jiu's mother was the princess of the Nandu family, just like my Jiu. Is she also studying at Donghai Academy now? You need to find out for yourself. Hua Fengliu smiled. Okay. Yi Fushan nodded and left Hua Fengliu to rest. He went back to Tang Lan, and she said to Yi Fushan, looks like you guys are getting along with each other. Professor was injured because of me, Yi Fushan said. He was trying to protect me, reactivated his natal spirit, and suffered this irreversible injury as a result. Is there any possibility that he could be cured by someone in this city? That is nuts. Tang Lan was shocked by what Hua Fengliu had done for Yi Fushan. To cure him, we would need a special mandate sorcerer who is a healing sorcerer with mental power. Besides, he would have to be more powerful than your professor. It would be almost impossible to find someone like that. There is not a single person in the city of Donghai. Yi Fushan's hope was rebuilt. He would do anything he could to cure Hua Fengliu. In fact, there is. Tang Lan had thought of someone. She realized Yi Fushan was looking at her with expectation, so she told him, just give up. Your professor would be happy enough that you are even thinking about how to cure him. Please, Miss Tang, tell me. Yi Fushan looked stubborn. He's not going to do it. Tang Lan shook her head. Yi Fushan was disappointed. He understood that Tang Lan had her reasons for not telling him. Goodbye, boy. Take care of your professor and get a good rest, Tang Lan said. Thanks, Miss Tang. Yi Fushan knew that Miss Tang had helped them a lot by letting them stay there, and he was grateful. Professor is so lucky to have you. This is life, Tang Lan sighed. Which part of professor attracted you to him in the first place? Yi Fushan asked. Boy, he was handsome, Tang Lan answered and left, leaving Yi Fushan standing there, surprised. Yu Sheng looked him in the face, then mumbled, no wonder why so many girls like you. You do have a pretty face. Yi Fushan pretended to be mad and stared at Yu Sheng. However, when he turned around, he couldn't stop laughing. He was so eager to cultivate at Donghai Academy. This academy was apparently the best in all of the East Sea Prefecture. In fact, countless people came to this academy every year and tried their best to be admitted. However, only those with extraordinary talents could become students. The rest just gave up their first choice and went to the academies that were not as excellent. This was why everyone in Donghai Academy could be considered geniuses, and a virtuous cycle was formed that let this academy become even more powerful over time. The powerful sorcerers such as the Gun Devil, Art Saint, and Tang Lan had all attended Donghai Academy. For a powerful family like Nandu, Donghai Academy had become the first and only choice for their offspring. Meanwhile, at Donghai Academy, a beautiful girl was inscribing. She was about 16 years old, and she was focused entirely on her work. This concentration shed a holy glow on her body. Hua Jiu, someone called her. Another pretty girl had entered. She was not as gorgeous as the one inscribing though. What's going on? Hua Jiu paused her work and looked at the girl. Someone is inviting you to dinner, she smiled at Hua Jiu. A guy? Hua Jiu asked peacefully. No, it's a girl, and all she wants is to be overshadowed by your beauty at the dinner, the girl said jokingly. I'm sorry, I can't go, Hu Jiu picked up her pen. The girl looked awkward. Why don't you even ask who he is? I can't go, Hu Jiu insisted. The girl almost gave up. Can't you at least try this time? I promise you this is one of the greatest boys at this academy. The girl tried for the last time. I have a boyfriend, Hu Jiu explained. The girl was surprised and asked, you're not making this up, are you? Hu Jiu shook her head. The girl realized she was serious. She sighed. Oh my, so many boys at this academy are going to have broken hearts. Is this boy at the academy? No, Hu Jiu answered. Is he an amazing boy? It must be really difficult to get you to fall in love, the girl said. The image of Yi Fushan came into her mind. Then she suddenly started smiling. That smile was soul-capturing. It was utterly irresistible, even for the girl next to her. He is a bad boy. Hu Jiu didn't stop smiling. That smile was so sweet. The girl could see that Hu Jiu was definitely not lying. She looked like she was in love. Chapter 47, Donghai Academy. The moon hung high in the night sky and the sound of Qin resonated in the Qin Gardens. The music seemed to be able to bring its listeners peace. From the music, one could feel happiness and a longing for love. In front of one of the buildings at the Qin Gardens, Tang Lan laid silently in a hammock, listening to the music. It brought her back to her youth and elicited memories from the past. She could not help but smile while she reminisced. Master, a gentle voice sounded. Tang Lan opened her eyes and was met with the sight of a sweet-looking young woman underneath the moonlight. The young woman's eyes were clear and pure, but carried curiosity when she looked at Tang Lan. She had approached Tang Lan without being noticed, and what was more, she saw a smile on her master's face. Her smile was beautiful, but the young woman had never seen it before. Was it because of the music? Tang Lan, why are you back? Tang Lan asked. I wanted to come back to see you, master, Tang Lan answered softly. Master, who is playing the Qin? It sounds like they are trying to convey a certain feeling. He is back. The person playing is his disciple, Tang Lan answered. She never expected Yi Fushan to be on par with Hua Fengliu at such a young age. His music was able to pluck a person from reality, pulling them into the mood of the piece. He? Tang Lan was puzzled at first but then remembered the person Tang Lan kept in her heart all these years. Her eyes twinkled. The Qin Devil? Yes. Since you're back anyway, you can show his disciple around Donghai Academy tomorrow. Help him get familiar with the environment. When he enters the academy next year, you'll be schoolmates. Tang Lan chuckled and continued, but that rascal is good with words. Don't be tricked by his sweet talk. Tang Lan blushed. Tang Lan said the guy playing the Qin was a sweet talker. What could he have said to Tang Lan for her to say that? Go now, get some more rest. From now on, you don't have to worry so much about me. Focus on cultivation, Tang Lan said gently. Of her two female disciples, she favored this younger disciple more. Tang Lan was young and beautiful, sweet and enchanting. She was very much like Tang Lan when she was a young girl. Tang Lan hoped that her beloved disciple would not end up like herself. I understand, master, Tang Lan replied. She turned and left the area but did not head back to her own living space. She followed the sound of the music and arrived at the building in which Hua Fengliu and Yi Fushan were staying. In front of the building, she saw a young man quietly strumming at the chords of the Qin. He seemed to have fallen deep into the music. A smile adorned his face, which made him seem much more attractive. Tang Lan did not walk up to disturb him. Instead, she listened wordlessly from where she stood until the piece ended. The young man lifted his head and Tang Lan gave him a warm smile. That was beautiful. Thank you. My name is Yi Fushan. Are you Ms. Tang Lan's disciple? Asked Yi Fushan with a smile. Yes. My name is Tang Lan. My master wants me to take you around Donghai Academy tomorrow. Do you want to go? Asked Tang Lan. That sounds great, he nodded. Then, I'll come find you tomorrow. Tang Lan smiled and was on her merry way. Yi Fushan stood up, grabbed his Qin and entered the bamboo forest behind the building. A rustling noise came from the bamboo forest. There also seemed to be a low hum. Up ahead, Yi Fushan could see the stalks of bamboo shaking from a gust of strong wind. When he walked closer to the area, he could see Yu Sheng seated on the ground. His body was surrounded by a dim golden light, making his already intimidating physique even scarier. At the same time, his face seemed to be slightly contorted, as if he were suffering from great pain. The low hum from before was coming from within Yu Sheng. It was as if a ferocious force was attacking his body from the inside. Yi Fushan sat down on the ground and placed his gun down in front of him. He began to play again. Under the sound of music, the suffering young man seemed to have calmed down, but the scary force continued to attack. It growled and roared, almost like it was ready to devour Yu Sheng. After a long while, the force finally calmed down. Yu Sheng opened his eyes, but the look on his face was icy cold. However, when he looked over and saw Yi Fushan, his gaze started to warm up. "Yu Sheng, how long did your father say you had to cultivate this technique?" asked Yi Fushan. "Forever," answered Yu Sheng. "Can't you stop?" Yi Fushan felt terrible. "It's fine," Yi Sheng scratched his head and smiled. "This way, I can become stronger." "You dummy. Rest well," said Yi Fushan. He left after picking up his gun. However, Yu Sheng did not go rest. After Yi Fushan left, he started to cultivate again. Yi Fushan had almost been hounded to death on Mount Danyao. Now that they were in the city of Donghai, there were even more powerful cultivators here. He had not cultivated long enough. At the plane he was in now, he was not capable of protecting Yi Fushan. He had to become stronger and more powerful as quickly as possible. The next morning, Donghai City was basked in the warmth of the bright sunlight. In the Qin Gardens, Tang Lan sent people to take care of Hua Fengliu bright and early. Yi Fushan felt bad for him, though, because everyone Tang Lan sent was male. Hua Fengliu tried to protest in a roundabout way. He said that there were some things that females do in better detail. To this, Tang Lan replied, "There's me." Hua Fengliu could only cry on the inside. He should have known better than to come back to the Qin Gardens. This was pure revenge. Yi Fushan was still laughing as he stepped out of the residence. He, along with Yu Sheng and Tang Lan, departed on the Black Wind Eagle. In the air, Yi Fushan looked down at the large city. His feelings about the city down below were complicated. He was afraid of it, but at the same time he wanted to conquer it. "Tang Wang, are there a lot of geniuses at Donghai Academy?" Yi Fushan asked. "Yeah, all the geniuses from well-known families all across the East Sea Prefecture are usually sent to Donghai City to further their education, and, of course, Donghai Academy is the first choice. For example, people say that over half of all the young mandate sorcerers in the East Sea Prefecture are gathered at Donghai Academy," Tang Wan explained. Yi Fushan slowly nodded. He could understand this. It was only natural for families of mandate sorcerers to want to send their children to study at the best academy. "Are you feeling stressed?" Tang Wan smiled at Yi Fushan. Her smile was sweet and beautiful. "Stress?" Yi Fushan wanted to smile. "Doesn't exist." "Looks like you're pretty confident," chuckled Tang Wan. Yi Fushan did not reply, but instead threw her a question. "By the way, have you heard of a person named Hua Jiu at the academy? She's about your age. With Fox's looks, it would be impossible for people at the academy not to know her." At the mention of this name, Tang Wan gave Yi Fushan a strange look. "You aren't planning to try anything with Donghai Academy's number one beauty, are you?" "Donghai Academy's number one beauty?" Yi Fushan was dumbfounded. Almost immediately, a huge smile spread across his face. She was actually here. Furthermore, she was more well-known than he thought. She really was a fox. "Didn't she just get into Donghai Academy?" Yi Fushan asked curiously. "Yeah, but her performance at the spring quarter entrance exams was incredible. All the higher-ups were shocked. Plus, I heard she comes from an impressive background. So, her popularity skyrocketed as soon as she entered the academy. She was the talk of the town. Also, with her looks, it's only natural that she was crowned the academy's number one beauty," Tang Wan explained. "Do you have a crush on her?" "I think you should just forget about it." Yi Fushan looked at Tang Wan. It looked like she didn't know about Hua Jiu's background. If she did, then she would have been able to guess that Yi Fushan and Hua Jiu knew each other. "Why?" he asked. "Hua Jiu has countless suitors at the academy, but even the most popular guys have all been turned down. So, I don't think you have a chance." Tang Wan gave him a light smile. "I get it, Yi Fushan's smile got even bigger. Do you know why she turns all of them down? Probably because she's too prideful, said Tang Wan. It's because she already has someone she likes, he said. Who? Tang Wan was curious. Me? Answered Yi Fushan, smiling at Tang Wan. She smirked. Master said you were good with words. Turns out they were for bluffing. Yi Fushan was speechless in response to her comment. Then, thinking about Tang Lan, said he felt a bit upset. After dropping off the trio, the Black Wind Eagle was off again. Donghai Academy was majestic. The main doors were open, allowing access to anyone and everyone. In all of the East Sea Prefecture, no one dared to cause trouble at Donghai Academy, so the academy never had to worry about preventing intrusions. Students came and went. The youngest was around the age of 13 or 14, and the oldest was not over 20. Everyone looked upbeat. The campus was vibrant. There are so many pretty girls here, said Yi Fushan as they entered. Hearing his very first comment about Donghai Academy, Tang Wan felt many pairs of judging eyes on them. It was embarrassing. As people walked past them, they could not help but stare. Yi Fushan was handsome. Tang Wan was beautiful, and Yu Sheng looked strong and intimidating. Naturally, this trio would attract a lot of attention. At this time, a pair of eyes landed on Yi Fushan and his friends. The corners of her mouth lifted into a smug smile. It's him, said a young woman around the age of 16. Miu Yuni, is he someone you know? Asked a classmate of hers. Yi Fushan was heading in their direction. His eyes did a quick sweep and saw the Miu siblings from yesterday amongst a group of people. It was hard to tell whether or not they were smiling at him. Can I help you with something? Asked Yi Fushan. The siblings had walked up to him. When Miu Yuni saw how confident Yi Fushan looked, she was reminded of how pitiful he had looked to her the day before. She snickered at him. Found someone else to back you up? What's it to you? He asked with a smile. Nothing. I'm just asking, she laughed. Then the group brushed past Yi Fushan and continued on their way. Right after walking past Yi Fushan, Miu Yuni told the person next to her, that guy is the Ken Devil's disciple, but the Ken Devil is now handicapped. He even had the nerve to come to my house and beg my father to take in his disciple. Isn't that such a joke? Yi Fushan heard her words and stopped in his tracks once again. He turned to Tang Wan and jostled his shoulders. What happens if I beat someone up at Donghai Academy? Chapter 48, I won't leave because I need to find my girlfriend. Tang Wan looked at Yi Fushan with curiosity. Why would he pick a fight even before being admitted to the academy? However, Miu Yuni was very rude. If it had been her own master who was insulted, she wouldn't have taken it either. Students are not allowed to bully each other at Donghai Academy, but friendly competition is encouraged. Therefore, any fight voluntarily initiated by both parties of students will not be interfered with by the academy administrators. However, the parties in competition must make sure they have full control of their violence, which means no casualties allowed. Tang Wan mumbled to Yi Fushan, since you're not a student of this academy, if you insult the students here you will probably get your ass kicked. Yi Fushan felt awkward. Why didn't Tang Wan believe in him? The group of people around Miu Yuni stopped walking when they overheard Yi Fushan and Tang Wan's conversation. Miu Yuni gave Yi Fushan a glance in confusion. Someone started telling her, Miu Yuni, this guy wants to kick your ass. Miu Yuni mocked Yi Fushan. Why are you agitated? Am I wrong? Who was there at my house, begging my dad to accept him? Why don't you just beg me, and maybe I'll be nice and persuade my dad to give you a place? Yi Fushan looked at Miu Yuni and said, I'm mad now. So what? Miu Yuni was still smiling at him. People around her were also laughing. Mad? Did it mean anything? So, Yi Fushan yelled, Yu Sheng, I'm ready. Yu Sheng clenched his fists and stepped forward. At that moment, Tang Wan felt that this big guy had become a beast. His body exuded a sense of danger. You are a three-star glory plane warrior. Don't tell me you're afraid to fight, Yi Fushan said to Miu Yuni. Yuni, I'll take him, a guy next to her said. I will challenge you all, Yu Sheng announced. Tang Wan was shocked. Even she knew that Yu Sheng was definitely stronger, But he was still a bit overconfident. He was challenging six Donghai Academy students who were elite amongst their peers. Some of them might even be mandate sorcerers. Yi Fushan wasn't worried at all. Yu Sheng had been practicing techniques inherited from his father since he reached the seventh plane of awakening. Additionally, he had exceptional talent. Therefore, his power could not be measured merely by plane. He knew what Yu Sheng was trying to do. If he challenged only one student and other people got involved, then it was no longer a friendly competition. They were new to this place, so they still had to comply with the rules. Yu Sheng was very smart by challenging all those students. Mu Yani and her brother looked embarrassed. The people who came to their house begging their father to accept them were now challenging all of them. How can I reject you, since you're asking for it? Mu Yanqing didn't take Yu Sheng seriously. However, he still had absolute confidence. He was only 17 years old but already a 4-star glory plane mandate sorcerer. He was indeed one of the top students at Donghai Academy. The moment he agreed to fight, Yu Sheng stomped on the ground, and his body shot toward Mu Yanqing. He had endured this family long enough. Since Huafeng Liu was rejected and humiliated yesterday, he believed it was now time to teach them a lesson. The ground fissured and Yu Sheng's body was covered with a dark golden glow, as if he was wearing solid armor. He was much taller than the average person, and with the armor, he almost looked like a knight sent by God. This boy is so. Tang Wan was shocked. Yu Sheng had not even reached Mu Yanqing yet, and Tang Wan had already perceived the real power in his body. Not only Tang Wan, but other people being challenged obviously sensed Yu Sheng's power. Two people stepped forward, and both of them started to condense elemental power into spells. One of them created a chain that appeared from the ground to shackle Yu Sheng's body, and another one shot a sharp golden arrow in his eyes. Yu Sheng blocked the attacks by merely putting his arms in front of his body. The golden arrow broke into pieces the moment it reached his arms, and the chain was easily torn apart. Yu Sheng had almost reached their bodies when they started to flee from Yu Sheng's range of melee attack. Their speed was breakneck, because both of them were powerful mages who also cultivated martial arts techniques. Unfortunately for them, Yu Sheng was faster. They saw a golden giant blocking their way. They were frightened because they had never seen anyone who could corner them in a fight like Yu Sheng did. He was so fast that they were defeated before they had fully employed the power of their attacks. Bang! Yu Sheng's arms swept onto them. They were knocked back to the ground, and their bodies were smashed. Yu Sheng kept charging forward towards Mu Yani. The ground was shaking with his steps. At that moment, Mu Yani's face turned deadly pale. She apparently had just realized this strong guy was way more powerful than she was. "Just go, I'll take him," Mu Yanqing told his sister. Mu Yani had to obey. She ran as Mu Yanqing started to attack Yu Sheng. She made sure she was in a safe place and started watching them fight. She believed her brother could take care of that crazy big guy, and then they could beat up Yi Fushan together. Other students of Donghai Academy were attracted to this place by the fight. The moment they saw Yu Sheng, they wondered why they had never met this guy before. They believed he was also a student of Donghai Academy, because he was mighty. Mu Yanqing unleashed the natal spirit he had inherited from his father. The natal spirit was a golden eagle. A golden eagle was a powerful monster that consisted of both gold and wind elements of power. It was similar to the Yi Fushan's divine bird. However, it was weaker. After the natal spirit was unleashed, wings appeared behind his body. His whole body was now floating in the air, and the horrifying power of gold and wind elements were condensing around him. The power then formed into sharp lances that were pointed at Yu Sheng. "Go!" Mu Yanqing's wings shook, and the lances suddenly started rushing at Yu Sheng, piercing the air. With enhancement from his wind element, the lances were much faster than expected. Yu Sheng didn't try to dodge the attacks at all. He directly swung his arms toward the lances. People were shocked at how it was possible for a warrior to destroy the spells with martial arts techniques. The moment Yu Sheng's arms made contact with the lances, a golden shadow enveloped his body. The golden shadow soon turned into whirlpools and began to engulf all the spiritual chi of the universe. The lances were quickly absorbed by the whirlpools, and after the lances were gone, Barbs grew out of Yuxiang's arms. Mu Yanqing didn't give up on his attacks. He held the sharpest lance by himself and charged toward Yuxiang. His body was as fast as thunder, and people started to worry about Yuxiang. Yuxiang swung his arms again. However, this time the barbs detached from his arms and shot toward Mu Yanqing. Mu Yanqing blocked the barbs by closing his wings to entirely cover his body. However, this movement also blocked his own sight. When he opened up the arms again, Yuxiang was almost in melee range. Mu Yanqing could do nothing but run away from the momentum of Yuxiang. Yuxiang definitely would not let him go that easily. He stomped hard on the ground, and it began to crack under him. His body suddenly rushed toward Mu Yanqing. People witnessed Mu Yanqing being approached by a golden light. "Be careful." Mu Yani tried to alert her brother. It was too late. Mu Yanqing was shocked to find himself caught by Yuxiang. Yuxiang's arms were clamping on his foot. He couldn't fight against what happened next. With a sudden pull, he was smashed to the ground. With a loud thump, Mu Yanqing's body hit the ground. He laid there, entirely immobilized. What a beast. The audience was shocked by this absolute power. Was he really a warrior? Yuxiang's power had transformed their attitudes toward martial arts cultivators. They had never seen a warrior who could trounce a mandate sorcerer. Yuxiang kept stepping forward. People around Mu Yani moved out of his way because they were too frightened to fight against this guy. Mu Yanqing had already shown them that Yuxiang was overwhelming. "What are you doing?" Mu Yani was overcome with fear when she saw Yuxiang walking toward her. She was trying to run away by unleashing her natal spirit, which was also a golden eagle. That little resistance did not cause any trouble for Yuxiang. He easily grabbed Mu Yani by the arm. She did not dare attack him since he was now as ferocious as a beast. The next moment she was being pulled to her brother. "Let me go," she screamed. Yuxiang smashed her to the ground next to her brother. They were both now lying on the ground, severely injured. "Now you know that your father does not deserve to be his professor." Yuxiang was humiliating them to return the humiliation they had suffered yesterday. Huafeng Liu had brought them to their house, and this family had rejected them. They had been destined to taste revenge because of Yuxiang's bad temper. Yuxiang's fury was gone. He was no longer a beast, just a big boy. He quietly walked back to Yifushan. It took a long while for Mu Yanqing and his sister to stand up again. They were staring at Yifushan and Yuxiang with resentment. "I'll remember you." Mu Yani gnashed his teeth in anger. "Go ahead, tell your father that you've been beaten by us." Yifushan kept humiliating them. Mu Yani was so angry. However, there was nothing she could do. It would be a shame if they had to go back and tell their father about the fight. Mu Yanqing and his sister were crestfallen. Tang Wan looked at Yifushan and believed he was talking like that intentionally. There were a lot of people watching, so these guys would definitely not tell their father what had happened. "Looks like you have to go." Tang Wan forced out a smile. These guys had beat up students on the first day they came to the school. It was impossible for them to stay here any longer. "You told me that professors at Donghai Academy don't care whether we fight." Yifushan was confused. "They won't, but those you just beat have classmates who do care," Tang Wan said. "It's okay. I still need to find my girlfriend." Yifushan ignored her warning. Tang Wan followed him and asked in a lowered voice, "Who is your girlfriend?" "Don't tell me it's Hua Jiu." "How did you know that?" Yifushan responded. Tang Wan was surprised and stopped talking. Chapter 49, Violence. Donghai Academy was enormous. After exploring more of the academy, the architecture on campus really opened Yifushan's eyes. The buildings were erected on ascending stairs. To see the building at the very top of the stairs, one would have to tilt their head toward the sky. A magnificent view indeed. Donghai Academy consists of 7 schools: the schools of the Emperor Star, Ruinous Star, Power Star, Flirting Star, Treasury Star, Finance Star, and Minister Star. That group from before was from School of the Flirting Star, and your girlfriend is from the School of the Emperor Star, explained Tang Wan. Her eyes were full of distrust when she used the word girlfriend. Back in Qingzhou Academy, the schools were divided by occupation. "Does Donghai Academy do that?" asked Yifushan. "No, Each of the seven schools consists of cultivators from different classes. Each school has their own powerful figures backing them up. It's all really complicated. While they help develop the schools, these powerful figures are also trying to increase their own powers. Tang Wan lowered her voice and explained to Yi Fushan. So complicated, said Yi Fushan. Yeah, nodded Tang Wan, because things are this way. The competition between the schools is very rigorous, and they pick fights with each other all the time. But within the schools, everyone is very united. So, when Yu Sheng picked that fight with the group from the School of the Flirting Star, it was the equivalent of picking a fight with their whole school. I personally think it's best for you both to leave for the time being. Yi Fushan smiled but did not say anything. Tang Wan continued. Plus, Hu Jiu was handpicked by the officials of the Emperor Star School as soon as she entered the academy. So, she's not among the ordinary student pool anymore. She cultivates up at the Emperor Star building. You wouldn't be able to go up there even if she was your girlfriend. She certainly is incredible, Yi Fushan muttered to himself. He turned around and saw the crowd following from afar. Everyone saw what had happened between them and the students from the Flirting Star School and knew that group would never let them go so easily. So, now they followed Yi Fushan and his friends in anticipation of what would happen next. If I leave now, would I lose face? Yi Fushan asked for Tang Wan's opinion. She stared at him. How was he still in the mood to joke around? She had no idea what he was thinking. Just as they were speaking, a group of people approached looking almighty. Mu Yanqing and Mu Yunyi, who had just been defeated by Yu Sheng, were also among them. The way they looked at Yi Fushan and Yu Sheng was not friendly at all. They could not believe that he really chose to stick around. He really was not afraid to die. Yi Fushan realized that his opponents had him and his friends surrounded. He looked to Mu Yunyi and said, "And here I was, wondering how arrogant you guys were. Is this all you've got?" Mu Yunyi could not say anything to that, but no matter what, they had to have their revenge. The group moved in closer to Yi Fushan. Determined and ferocious, Yi Fushan asked Tang Wan, "Can I reject their challenge?" Tang Wan rolled her eyes. He would not leave when she told him to, and now that he has beaten these people up, he wanted to turn down their challenge? There was no way they were going to let him go. "Take care of yourself," Tang Wan said weakly. She then took several steps back without a word. Yi Fushan stared at her, eyes wide, jaw open. Where was the loyalty? Different types of spiritual chi flowed crazily. The group of these people closed in on Yu Sheng carefully. "Yu Sheng, make a move," said Yi Fushan. As soon as he spoke, Yu Sheng charged forward wildly. Several of the more powerful cultivators surrounded Yu Sheng. Their sorcery erupted all at once. Vines thicker than his arm curled around Yu Sheng's body, entangling his arms and legs. This was earth elemental sorcery. Soon, his entire body was buried beneath the vines. Ice seal. A gush of cold air rolled in and further buried Yu Sheng and the vines in a layer of ice. Boom. The loud sound had come from Yu Sheng's right foot. His ice-covered foot took a large step forward, and the spell was broken. Above his violent figure appeared a dim golden light, and he continued to charge forward at the opposing group. "Disperse," ordered the leader of the group. Immediately, a wind spell was cast over the whole group, aiding them in a speedy getaway. Then, the spell formed a bubble and encapsulated Yu Sheng. Yi Fushan squinted his eyes at the scene. It was very obvious that the group benefited from having cultivators of different elements work together. This made them stronger in battle. The Mu siblings led a few people in Yi Fushan's direction. Their hatred of him surpassed that of Yu Sheng, who was the one who had actually defeated them in battle. Two people charged at Yi Fushan as their spiritual chi went haywire. From one of their bodies, the roar of a tiger was emitted, and his spiritual chi created a golden tiger. The person's speed also increased to that of a tiger. He pounced on Yi Fushan with an outstretched hand. The hand as slightly curved, as if to mimic a tiger's paw. This person was a metal elemental cultivator of martial and divination arts. He was using metal elemental spiritual chi to fight in close range. "Third level of the glory plane," said Yi Fushan. He could feel his opponent's aura. Yi Fushan remained unmoved as a ferocious earth elemental force erupted from his body. Faintly, People were able to see a giant ape appear on Yi Fushan's body. Born from the collection of spiritual qi, the ape possessed an inhumane amount of strength. Even though both animals had been formed from spiritual qi, Yi Fushan's giant ape was obviously more intimidating than the tiger demon. As his opponent got closer, Yi Fushan stuck out his arm. With one loud growl of the giant ape, the image of the tiger exploded. Following that, the giant hand of the ape demon wrapped around the opponent's neck and picked him up off the ground. A second later, he was smashed into the ground. The loud crash mimicked that of the Mu siblings' hearts. Yi Fushan smiled at the two and proceeded to race towards them. At the same time, the second person had also approached Yi Fushan without hesitation was knocked out by a single punch. Mu Yunqing and Mu Yunyi released their life spirits and were lifted into the air. Even though they had been injured during the previous fight, they were still capable of battle. At this moment, a bright light shone from Yi Fushan's back as he ran. The wings of the rock carried him up into the air as well. At the speed of lightning, he flashed before the siblings. The body of a dragon, strength of an ape, and the agility of a rock, a mandate sorcerer with a rock spirit. People were amazed as they witnessed this scene. It was rare to meet a mandate sorcerer, but even more rare to meet a mandate sorcerer with a rock spirit. Different life spirits were able to bring the mandate sorcerer different levels of power. For example, both the rock and the golden eagle were wind and metal by elemental life spirits, but the power from the rock brought Yi Fushan more power, making it super easy to defeat the golden eagle. Furthermore, life spirits grew along with the mandate sorcerers. Strong life spirits would only get stronger with time. Tang Wan was dumbfounded. No wonder Yi Fushan was so arrogant. Turns out he had every right to be. Watch out, warned Mu Yunqing. By the time he completed his warning, Yi Fushan had already arrived in front of him. Mu Yunqing did not look too good. He proceeded to rush toward Yi Fushan even though he knew his life spirit could not compare to that of Yi Fushan, but he was in a higher plane. He did not believe he would lose to Yi Fushan. The two orbs of golden light clashed in the air. The people below watched as the two continued their close-range combat. How can he be so strong? People questioned Yi Fushan's powers as they watched him fight a cultivator of a higher level than himself. He even had the upper hand. Soon, Mu Yunqing was struck by Yi Fushan's fist and lost his balance. In the next second, Yi Fushan had already placed his foot on his body, slamming Mu Yunqing directly into the ground. This was too violent. Mu Yunyi began to run away again when she noticed Yi Fushan's attention shifted to her. This time was no different from her battle with Yu Sheng. The only exception was that this time was more direct than the last. One punch and she was off. The Mu siblings were cruelly defeated twice in a day. This may leave a deep emotional scar on the both of them. Many people could not bear to look at Mu Yunyi. She was a pretty girl. After all, Yi Fushan and Yu Sheng should have taken it easy on her. Back on Yu Sheng's side, there were also multiple people lying on the ground. Yu Sheng was too wild, just like the god of war. Had it not been for the alliance of different elemental sorcerers, no one would have been able to compete with Yu Sheng, not even the two five-starred glory plane cultivators. In a flash, Yi Fushan attacked a wind elemental sorcerer in the air. Very quickly, the sorcerer was pushed far away. It was pitiful. The school of the flirting star is screwed, everyone thought to themselves. They had obviously underestimated Yi Fushan and Yu Sheng's powers. The only ones standing now were the two five-starred glory plane cultivators. However, after Yi Fushan joined Yu Sheng, Yu Sheng was like a beast who had just broken free. In one quick sweep, the whole lot was lying on the ground. They all looked so ferocious when they arrived, but now pitiful was the only word to describe them. Many people pitied the school of the flirting star. This was incredibly humiliating for them. Who were these two anyway? They were way too violent. A black winged eagle swooped down from the skies and landed by Yi Fushan. Let's go, Yu Sheng. The two walked to the eagle. Tang Wan rolled her eyes at Yi Fushan. He did know when to make an escape. My girlfriend will come looking for you. When she does, bring her to the Qin Gardens, Yi Fushan whispered in Tang Wan's ear. Then, they mounted the black winged eagle and descended into the vast sky. He wasn't really dumb enough to walk into the school of the Emperor Star screaming for his girlfriend. Remember, "My name is Yifushan," Yifushan screamed. His words were heard by everyone down below. To the students of the Flirting Star School, his words were a form of mockery. Tang Wan thought of the words Yifushan had left her with. A strange look crossed her eyes. Could this have been his true intention? "Hu Aji will come looking for me," she mumbled to herself. At the thought of the beautiful girl, she shook her head lightly. She must have been overthinking. Yifushan is always joking around. Maybe this was also a joke. In the air, Yifushan watched as Donghai Academy got smaller and smaller. He then muttered under his breath, "Fox, this was the only way I could think of to let you know. I'm here." Chapter 50. They finally meet again. The news that students from the School of the Flirting Star were defeated soon spread around the Donghai Academy like wildfire. If it had merely been friendly competition within the academy, people wouldn't have reacted so strongly. However, in this fight, two students who were known as geniuses at this academy were entirely crushed by two unknown boys below their planes. This was huge news. Besides, the audience may have somewhat embellished the details of the fight. They had told other students that one boy was a stud with explosive power like a monster. They claimed that it was impossible to find someone more talented than this strong guy in Donghai Academy, and in the future, he was going to be a legend. Still, a lot of prodigies at this academy didn't buy it. They considered the other boy a freak. He was a mandate sorcerer, specializing in both sorcery and martial arts. His natal spirit was a divine bird. What was even more impressive was that both his speed and his strength were at the top level. He had easily toppled Mu Yunqing, who was actually two planes higher than him. Plus, this boy was really arrogant. When he left, he had announced that people should remember his name, Yifushan. People started to discuss their origin, and some of them came to Tang Wan because she knew these boys. Students in the School of the Emperor Star were also discussing. In fact, those truly powerful students didn't care at all. They had always believed that they were too talented to be compared to others. They had considered the friendly competition that had happened at the academy small. However, there were some among them who enjoyed gossiping about these small-time fights. Xu Yuan was one of them. She was a lively girl who enjoyed making fun of people. On the top floor of the School of the Emperor Star, Xu Yuan entered the room, and she saw another beautiful girl standing beside the window, looking down at the scenery below. That was one of the spots where people were able to enjoy the full view of Donghai Academy. "Hu Jiu, my heart trembles even when I just see you standing there." Xu Yuan started with a compliment. Hu Jiu turned to her, smiled and said, "No more party invitations. I'm not going anywhere." I know, my goddess. "Can't we just chat?" Xu Yuan knew she had been misunderstood. "Did you know that something funny happened yesterday? Some students from the School of the Flirting Star were beaten up by outsiders. And more amazingly, the outsiders were in lower planes. Is it possible that some other academy in the city of Donghai sent these guys to intentionally provoke us?" Xu Yuan started to talk about the exciting fight yesterday. "I don't know," Hu Jiu answered. She seemed not to be interested at all. People said both of them were really cute. One was strong and wild as a beast, and the other one was particularly handsome. It was also said that a lot of girls witnessing the fight were hopelessly attracted to the boys. They fought over who was more handsome and charming. Xu Yuan went on, "So, which one do you prefer?" Hu Jiu smiled and asked, "I wasn't there." The handsome boy seemed to be really arrogant. He claimed that we should remember his name when he left. Xu Yuan laughed. Did he truly believe that he was more talented than all the geniuses at this academy? "You seem to be curious enough about it," Hu Jiu made fun of her. "And you're not curious at all. You know nothing but cultivation," Xu Yuan refuted. Okay, I know you're not interested at all. See you." When she turned around to leave, she was mumbling, "Yifushan, this name is arrogant enough to be remembered." Hu Jiu heard the name, and her body trembled with shock. She stopped Xu Yuan and asked, "What was that name again?" Xu Yuan looked at her and said, "Yifushan, it's the name of the handsome one." She was confused when Hu Jiu heard the name and suddenly started laughing. This was the first time Xu Yuan had seen such bright laughter on her face. She asked, What's wrong with you? Hua Jiu was laughing too hard to stop at that moment. She didn't answer the question. Come on, don't tell me you're attracted to him just because of his name. Xu Yuan was really curious. No, I'm not. Hua Jiu finally stopped laughing. She then asked, were there only two boys in the fight? They came with a student from the school of the minister star, Tang Wan, Xu Yuan told her. Okay, girl, thanks, Hua Jiu responded. See you later. After Xu Yuan left, Hua Jiu was still smiling. She looked so cute now and mumbled, no wonder people said he was a bad boy. Then she summoned the wind to carry her and jumped out the window. The way she landed was almost like an angel had descended to the world. Tang Wan was busy after Yi Fushan left, because quite a lot of people had asked her about Yi Fushan and Yu Sheng. These boys entirely lit up the curiosity of students at this academy. What made it even more awkward for her was that some girls who were attracted to these boys came to her and asked her to invite the boys on dates. She didn't take these jobs because she couldn't just go to the Gun Garden and tell the boys to go on a date. It would be so embarrassing. Tang Wan, someone's looking for you. Tang Wan was upset. It was so troublesome to have to answer questions about the boys again and again. Could you please just ignore your curiosity? Tang Wan complained. However, the person calling her said this time was not only about curiosity. Who is it? Tang Wan asked. Just go and check. Tang Wan peeked outside. She saw a gorgeous girl waiting for her quietly outside the door. Tang Wan was suddenly reminded of what Yi Fushan had said the day before. She now had a weird feeling that this girl was special. Come on, he wasn't joking. Hello, I'm Hua Jiu. She smiled and introduced herself. Tang Wan was absolutely confident in her own beauty. However, she still felt a bit overshadowed when she saw the girl standing outside. I'm Tang Wan. Could you please bring me to the boy? Hua Jiu asked politely. Tang Wan definitely understood who she was talking about. She nodded and said, follow me. Thanks. Hua Jiu followed Tang Wan. People wondered why these girls were walking together because they didn't know each other before today. Do you know that guy? Tang Wan was so curious that she finally asked. Yep. The image of Yi Fushan came into Hua Jiu's mind, and she started smiling again. So he wasn't lying to me yesterday, Tang Wan mumbled. What did he say? Hua Jiu asked her. Tang Wan looked at her for a while and said, he told me that you're his girlfriend. This guy. Hua Jiu flushed. She was shy. Tang Wan finally realized that Yi Fushan made such a scene yesterday only to let Hua Jiu know that he was already at the academy looking for her. What a sly boy. In fact, she wondered if the students of Donghai Academy knew what had happened here. How many hearts would be totally broken? Nope, I do not admit that, Hua Jiu tried to deny. However, her face was so red. How could Tang Wan believe her? When they entered the garden, they ran into Tang Lan. Greetings, Professor, Tang Wan said. Tang Lan was staring at Hua Jiu. Naturally, Hua Jiu reminded her of someone that had meant a lot in her life. Greetings, Miss Tang, Hua Jiu also greeted. Girl, you look exactly like her when she was young. Tang Lan was amazed. Hua Jiu knew that she was talking about her mother. She had spoken a lot with Tang Wan on the way here, and she knew who Tang Lan was. Tang Wan also knew that Hua Jiu was the daughter of Hua Fengliu, whose wife was her rival for the affections of Hua Fengliu. She had doubted whether she should bring Hua Jiu to this place. She felt as if she had made a mistake. Professor, I, Tang Wan faltered. It's not your fault, girl. Hua Jiu, go to your father. Tang Lan sighed. Thanks, Miss Tang. Hua Jiu walked into the garden with Tang Wan and Tang Lan following her. In front of the door, Hua Fengliu was sunbathing, and Yi Fushan was playing the gun. When they saw Hua Jiu, Yi Fushan stopped playing, and Hua Fengliu started to smile with kindness. Dad, Hua Jiu couldn't help crying. Tang Wan had told her that her father was severely injured. The sadness of seeing her father like this entirely drove away the happiness of their reunion. Hey, girl, don't cry. Hua Jiu hugged his daughter. However, he had even started crying himself. Yi Fushan stood by their side quietly, watching the scene of the reunion. Tang Lan asked Tang Wan, How did she know they were here? Tang Wan briefly explained what had happened. Tang Lan was surprised by the crazy thing Yi Fushan had done. She then turned to Tang Wan and warned her, "This boy is such a troublemaker. No wonder Hua Fengliu told me to keep an eye on him. Stay away from him, girl." "What are you talking about, professor?" Tang Wan was confused. "Beautiful girls are just dangerous. Both of these girls are gorgeous. Hopefully, this boy will not make the same mistake as his professor did." Tang Lan sighed. She believed that Hua Fengliu had fallen into such a situation because of that woman. Now, Hua Jiu looked exactly like that woman when she was young, but somehow even more beautiful. Tang Lan was afraid that several years later, when she became an adult, Yi Fushan would run into troubles because of this beautiful girl, just like his professor had. No matter what, there was such a substantial coincidence between these two generations. Chapter 51. You will remember his name. After crying for quite a while, Hua Jiu finally looked up at her father. Her eyes were red and bloodshot as she asked, "Father, what on earth happened after I left? How did things end up like this?" "Silly girl, it's all over now. Look, I'm sitting here safe and sound," Hua Fengliu consoled her gently. Hua Jiu stood up and turned to look at Yi Fushan. "What happened?" "Fox, it's my fault for not taking good care of Master. After you left, a monster tide washed over the city of King Su. There were people who wanted to kill me, and Master ended up like this because he was trying to protect me," said Yi Fushan. He still blamed himself for what had happened. Then, he remembered that Xia Fan was right here in Donghai City, and reminded himself that he had to get his revenge. "It's not Yi Fushan's fault. At the time, if he weren't so lucky, he would have been forced to his death on Mount Danyao. You know I have a bad temper. Obviously I wanted to get revenge for him, but I was useless. I didn't manage to kill the enemy, but instead harmed myself in the process," smiled as he spoke. He was seemingly unbothered by it all. "Is this true?" Hua Jiu asked Yi Fushan. He nodded lightly. Her tears fell once again. She walked up to Yi Fushan with her arms outstretched and pulled him into her arms. Hua Jiu rested her head on Yi Fushan and said, "Who allowed you to put yourself in danger? What would I do if you had died?" Hua Jiu's voice shook as she cried. The thought of her father being handicapped and Yi Fushan almost dying after she had left them made her even more frightened. Yi Fushan felt the warmth flood his body as she gently embraced him. He reached out his hands and wrapped them around her as well. He swore to himself to never let her cry like this again. Tang Wan stood not too far away. She shuddered as she witnessed the scene in front of her. It was true. The goddess of Donghai Academy had already given her heart to someone. If the students of Donghai Academy found out, many of them would impulsively want to kill Yi Fushan. Tang Wan knew there were quite a few of the geniuses at school who failed in their attempts to get closer to Hua Jiu. "At that time, I didn't get to see you again yet." "Of course, I couldn't die. You promised to compensate me," Yi Fushan said to Hua Jiu with a gentle voice. She lifted her head at him. She stared for a while then left his embrace. "I already did." "What?" Yi Fushan blinked in disbelief. "That was it? What else were you expecting?" Hua Jiu looked at Yi Fushan. "Then, just let me hold you for a little longer," Yi Fushan requested as he took a step forward. Hua Jiu stepped away from his advance and replied, "Don't try to change the subject. Who did this to my father?" Hua Jiu knew Yi Fushan was trying to cheer her up. He seemed to have a natural ability to do so. She was always happy when he was by her side. During the 3 months in which they spent every day together, the days went by in endless bickering. However, at the same time, he unknowingly made his way into her heart. "Can you trust me to handle it?" "I will get revenge. As for Master's condition, I will most definitely find a way to heal him," said Yi Fushan. This was something he had to take care of personally. He did not want Hua Jiu to get involved. "Hua Jiu, just let Yi Fushan handle it. It's perfect motivation for him." Hua Fengliu agreed with what Yi Fushan had said. Hua Jiu looked at both men and said, "Then, you have to promise me that you'll succeed." "If I don't succeed in this, how would I be able to marry you?" asked Yi Fushan. "Who says that I will marry you?" Hu Ajiyi blushed as she stared shyly at Yi Fushan. Can you love birds tone it down a little? It would be fine if it was just me, but there are other people here, said Hua Fengliu. Hua Jiu turned around and realized that Tang Lan and Tang Wan were still in the room. Her red cheeks got even redder. Yi Fushan, on the other hand, did not seem to mind. They'll get used to it, he said. Master, should we leave? Whispered Tang Wan. Yi Fushan was too shameless. He's worse than his master, Tang Lan said weakly. Afterward, the two of them left not wanting to disturb the group. Father, I want to stay here and take care of you, said Hua Jiu. Sure, she felt better after crying and joking around with Yi Fushan, but it would be impossible for her to recover from this sadness completely. Silly girl, you still have to cultivate. I will be fine here. Yi Fushan and Ms. Tang Lan are here to take care of me. After seeing you, I feel so much better already, chuckled Hua Fengliu. Then I'll stay for today. You can't make me leave, said Hua Jiu. All right, stay. I know you haven't seen Yi Fushan in a while, laughed Hua Fengliu. I don't want to see him, said Hua Jiu. Really now? Hua Fengliu looked at his daughter and could only laugh. Of course, Hua Jiu nodded. How sad, sighed Yi Fushan. And to think that I've been thinking of you every day and turning down advances from different girls. Looks like I'll have to rethink those opportunities now. You wouldn't dare. Hua Jiu whipped around to glare at Yi Fushan. Then, did you miss me? Yi Fushan chuckled at her. Father, has he been flirting with other girls? She asked her father. Yi Fushan blinked. Hua Fengliu wanted to laugh as he glanced at Yi Fushan. Yi Fushan looked so desperate that Hua Fengliu could only laugh. He kept to himself, Hua Fengliu answered. Yi Fushan let out a sigh of relief. Then, yeah, I missed you every now and then, whispered Hua Jiu ever so lightly, but Yi Fushan heard her anyway. Seeing the timid expression on Hua Jiu's face, Yi Fushan felt that she was someone worth giving up others for. I'm going to go cultivate, said Yu Sheng. He could no longer listen to this. He walked towards the bamboo forest behind the building. Did they really have to act all lovey-dovey every time they saw each other? Hua Fengliu and the couple chuckled at Yu Sheng's words. Yi Fushan called out to him. Yu Sheng, there are so many beautiful girls in Donghai City. If you find someone you like, I wouldn't mind being your wingman. Father said I can't be in a relationship, Yu Sheng said, not even turning his head to answer Yi Fushan. But your father isn't here, so whatever I say goes, Yi Fushan shouted. Yu Sheng had already disappeared around the corner. Only three people remained standing in front of the building. Under the sunlight, the sadness melted away, replaced with warmth. At this moment, an elderly man approached from the outside of the Qin Gardens. The powerful, icy force he gave off seemed to cause the temperature within the Qin Gardens to drop a couple degrees as he stepped inside. A figure appeared and stood in front of the elder. It was Tang Lan. Realizing who was standing in front of her, Tang Lan froze for a moment. Then, with a cold demeanor, she asked, "What are you doing here? Our young miss has been in there for quite some time now. Who did you guys bring her here to see?" asked the elder with an equally cold demeanor. "You were stalking her?" asked Tang Lan. "This isn't stalking," the elder said. He took a step forward and he was gone, his speed faster than the speed of light. "Presumptuous," yelled Tang Lan. The whole Qin Gardens was able to hear her. Hua Fengliu and Yi Fushan were alerted by the noise. They looked up and saw two figures descending from the skies, quick and forceful as lightning. "Hua Fengliu," the elder's gaze fell on Hua Fengliu. "You dare to step foot in the city of Donghai, Nanduku?" Hua Fengliu looked at the elder. "You were following me?" asked Hua Jiu. "Young miss, you are a person of utmost importance. The family would never feel at ease if you were to step out alone. Within Donghai Academy, I would not dare to meddle in your activities. However, as soon as you step off the academy premises, I will be there to protect your safety," explained Nanduku. "Nanduku, I am now a powerless person. I just wanted to come back to Donghai City for a visit. Can't you guys let me be?" asked Hua Fengliu. Nanduku looked puzzled. The Qin Devil was now powerless. "Since you're already powerless, then I can let you go about your business. The family already gave in and allowed young miss to accompany you for 3 years. However, Now that she has made it past the initial process of cultivation and has stepped into the critical period, the family doesn't wish for anyone or anything to distract her, said Nanduku. I'm just going to spend a little time with my father, then head back to Donghai Academy, said Hua Jiu coldly. Young miss, please don't put me in a difficult position. All those years ago, the family already agreed to your stubborn requests. If you keep acting this way, then your father will definitely not be allowed to stay in the city of Donghai, said Nandu. You guys wouldn't dare. Hua Jiu was furious. Hua Jiu, you should go back. Hua Fengliu opened his mouth to speak. Father. The strong aura around Hua Jiu dissipated as she turned to speak to her father. Hua Fengliu gave a warm and gentle smile. Sweetie, I'm fine here. Go back to cultivate at the academy and don't worry about me. Hua Jiu felt terrible. She gave Nanduku another cold glare. You guys dare to treat my father this way? Aren't you afraid that I'll retaliate once I complete my cultivation? Young miss, these things were decided by the family. I am not clear on the details. If you can recover the Nandu family's glory, I'm sure that they will be willing to grant your every wish, said Nanduku. Fine. That day will come, replied Hua Jiu. She then turned to Hua Fengliu and said, Father, I'm going now. Go, said Hua Fengliu, still smiling. Then, Hua Jiu looked at Yi Fushan. Their eyes met with longing and without a word, Hua Jiu turned to leave the Qin Gardens. Nanduku did not leave with her. After she left, he looked at Hua Fengliu and gave him a warning. You are clear that the family was not unwilling to accept you all those years ago, but it was you that could not become part of the family. But yet, you choose to reach for the stars and caused things to end up like this. You're lucky that young miss is extremely gifted. Her gift is a perfect combination of you and her mother. Therefore, the family will not allow anyone to get in the way of her cultivation. Hua Fengliu did not spare Nanduku a glance. The elder then turned to Yi Fushan, who was standing beside Hua Fengliu, and asked, And who is he? My disciple, Yi Fushan, answered Hua Fengliu. You brought your disciple with you? Are you setting all your hopes on him? Nanduku laughed at Hua Fengliu. That's some fantasy. You lost to him in the past. I bet now even his disciples are stronger than yours. When he was finally done, Nanduku turned to leave. Watching his departing figure, Hua Fengliu said, One day, you will remember his name. I look forward to that day. Nanduku left after his last words, disappearing from the Qin Gardens. Chapter 52, Just So-So. Yi Fushan kept silent while watching all this happen, but deep inside, he was not as calm as he looked. It took so much effort to meet his fairy again, and she had to leave soon after this reunion. It was understandable that he felt sad. You don't like this feeling, do you? Hua Fengliu perceived his gloom and asked him. Yi Fushan nodded. Why shouldn't I be sad? Then just keep training and grow stronger. Hua Fengliu closed his eyes. He was also pissed off because Nanduku had told him that his life was hopeless. He could do nothing but put all his hope in Yi Fushan. Although, he wasn't desperate, because he knew how talented Yi Fushan was. With the inheritance from Emperor Yi Qing, as long as he kept cultivating, people in the city of Donghai and the Nandu family would eventually bow down to his power. Therefore, he was trying to get Yi Fushan accepted into Donghai Academy, and it would be even better if one of the higher-ups of the academy picked him as a disciple personally. He needed a safe and promising environment for him to grow in. Yi Fushan didn't respond to Hua Fengliu, but he felt hot-blooded. He needed to be strong enough to protect his professor and girlfriend. The only time Yi Fushan went out was to buy inscribing pens and scrolls. Both scroll inscribing and Qin practice served as cultivation for him. They enhanced his mental power and ability in spiritual qi perception, which was critical for the development of a mage. As for martial arts techniques, he kept improving on the treasures Emperor Yi Qing had given him. With enough time, his body would be as invincible as the Divine Dragon and the Snow Ape. One day, Tang Wan came to their place. I have good news for you guys, Tang Wan smiled. What is it? Yi Fushan was curious. Someone from the School of the Finance Star told me that you have been admitted, Tang Wan said. Yi Fushan was confused and didn't believe it. I guess some supervisor in that school heard about the fight. I think he must have heard about it from a student. Otherwise, they would have been looking for you guys even sooner, Tang Wan elaborated. The talents Yi Fushan and Yu Sheng had demonstrated during that fight were obviously more than enough for them to be admitted. Unfortunately, there was no professor or supervisor in the audience. Wow, we just benefited from kicking someone's ass, Yu Sheng mumbled. Yi Fushan was also smiling. He was so happy that once he was admitted into Donghai Academy, it would be much easier to spend time with Hua Jiu. What are you talking about? Hua Fengliu was doubtful about this admission. It is uncommon for a school in Donghai Academy to make an exception for applicants. What did they do? Mr. Hua, you don't know what happened? The first time I brought them to Donghai Academy, they messed with some students from the School of the Flirting Star, because one of them, Miu Yunni, was being rude. These boys totally kicked their asses. This is how your daughter knew Yi Fushan was here and asked me to bring her to you, Tang Wan explained. Hua Fengliu finally understood what had happened. The last time Hua Jiu had come here, they were in such a rush that he didn't have time to ask for the details. Hua Fengliu gave Yi Fushan a glance. He was a little bit mad that this boy had not told him about the fight. Just go. Remember to take care of yourself, Hua Fengliu said. All right, professor, enjoy your private time with Miss Tang after we are gone, Yi Fushan teased him. Screw you, Hua Fengliu was embarrassed. Bye, professor. Yi Fushan was still somewhat worried about Hua Fengliu. He was too injured to live alone. Don't worry, I'll take care of him. Tang Lan came in at this time. She knew that Yi Fushan was worried, so she was trying to comfort him. Thank you so much, Yi Fushan said. Now he was settled. The Black Wind Eagle arrived and landed next to them. Yi Fushan, Yu Sheng, and Tang Wan got on her back. Then she soon took off into the air. Yi Fushan waved to Hua Fengliu, apparently reluctant to leave. Good luck, boy. Your new journey has just begun. Hua Fengliu was smiling. Looks like he's almost like a son to you. Why do you believe in him so much? Tang Lan was curious. Trust me, someday Donghai Academy will be proud of having such a student. Hua Fengliu was confident. Tang Lan was surprised and a bit confused. She believed that the confidence Hua Fengliu held for Yi Fushan was much stronger than she could have imagined. Within each of the seven schools at Donghai Academy, there were students of various classes for the purpose of diversity. However, there were also specific characteristics for each of them. It was all about the people who were supporting the schools. Students from the School of the Finance Star were known for great martial arts techniques. This was why the supervisor of this school had made an exception to admit Yi Fushan and Yu Sheng without a test. According to those who had witnessed the fight, both of them were incredibly talented at martial arts, especially Yu Sheng. The admission of Yi Fushan and Yu Sheng didn't quite cause a sensation at Donghai Academy, because only a few students had witnessed the fight, not to mention that most students just knew their names, but had never seen them. Besides, it had been a while since the fight took place. Tang Wan led them to the School of the Finance Star. They were well accommodated and brought around to tour the school. However, the supervisor who accepted them had not arranged a meeting with the boys. It was possible that he still wanted to give them some time to prove themselves first. Students in the School of the Finance Star lived in a separate area that consisted of dorms specifically assigned to them. In fact, the environment seemed to be better than that of Qingzhou Academy. Who are you? Someone passing by was curious about these new students. They had never met Yi Fushan and Yu Sheng before. I'm Yi Fushan, and this is my best friend, Yu Sheng. Yi Fushan was smiling. Yi Fushan, this name sounds familiar, the boy mumbled, and soon he remembered who they were. He quickly disappeared, and word started to spread in the School of the Finance Star that the students who kicked the asses of the students from the School of the Flirting Star had been admitted to this school. The word spread so quickly that suddenly, a lot of people were gathered around them. Is this guy Yi Fushan? Really? A two-star glory plane student? Yu Sheng looks exactly how people said. He's such a big guy. Is he merely a martial arts cultivator, or he is actually hiding some powerful natal spirit? Wow, they're so cute, Some girls were also gossiping. The students were curious about everything since they were so young. "Is there a library at this school?" Yi Fushan asked Tang Wan. Tang Wan shook her head. "There is only one library at Donghai Academy, and it's located right in the center of the campus. The entry is free to every student, but no checkouts are allowed. You may only browse the books and scrolls inside." Yi Fushan understood why checkout was prohibited. There were just so many students at this academy that books might be lost once checked out. "Let's go there," Yi Fushan said. He had already reached the two-star glory plane, but the spells he could initiate were still mostly basic. It was a huge waste of his talents. He believed that he was not supposed to give up sorcery cultivation, even though his martial arts inheritance from Emperor Yi Qing was so powerful. A combination of both would definitely make him stronger. "Sure," Tang Wan nodded. She was surprised that he was not just a pretty boy like he looked, and was in fact quite diligent. The first place he had wanted to go to was the library. The scale of the library at Donghai Academy was much larger than that of the one at Qingzhou Academy. Besides, there was no limit for the students. Any student at this academy would be allowed to browse all the collections in this library. Donghai Academy was very generous about this. When Yi Fushan entered the library, he was shocked by the comprehensiveness of the collection. There were books on general subjects like martial arts techniques, swords techniques, elemental spells, and even some very rare books on mental spells. He even found books about music spells, matrices, and scroll inscription. He totally understood why Huafeng Liu had insisted he study at this academy. During the following several days, Yi Fushan spent all his time making his way through the entire collection. Meanwhile, the news that Yi Fushan had been admitted to the School of the Finance Star finally spread all around the academy, including the School of the Flirting Star. They started looking for him everywhere, and finally, they found him in the library. Yi Fushan was reading books quietly when a group of angry people came up to him. Mu Yunqing spoke to him in rage. "Long time no see, Yi Fushan." "What's up?" Yi Fushan didn't even raise his head. "Since you're now admitted into this academy, I guess it's time for us to get even about what happened last time." Mu Yunqing sounded really mad. "Are you challenging me?" Yi Fushan looked at him with contempt. However, Mu Yunqing was not planning to fight by himself. "Someone from the School of the Flirting Star will represent me." "Who is it, and what plane is he in?" Yi Fushan asked. Mu Yunqing realized that other people were looking at him, and he faltered. "Are you still going to fight me together like you did last time?" Yi Fushan was laughing. He was now a student at this academy, so people who fought him had to abide by the rules, which was one-on-one. Mu Yunqing was extremely embarrassed. He didn't say anything, and the group left crestfallen again. This incident soon spread around the academy. Students started to make fun of Mu Yunqing. They now considered him to be a total coward. Several days later, it was announced that Jing Yang, a student from the School of the Flirting Star, had openly issued a letter of challenge to Yi Fushan. It caused a sensation at the academy. He was a three-star glory plane mandate sorcerer, a true prodigy. He had been personally admitted directly by the supervisor of the School of the Flirting Star as a disciple. Usually, he didn't care about friendly competition, but now, to save the reputation of his school, he challenged Yi Fushan publicly. However, the response from Yi Fushan left people totally speechless. "Sorry, I have no time for this." This was such a lame excuse to turn down the challenge. Students in the School of the Flirting Star accused him of being a real coward. Jing Yang, however, was not surprised. He told people that Yi Fushan was just so-so. Yi Fushan wasn't disturbed by these comments at all. He still spent all his time on reading and cultivating, as usual. Chapter 53. The Wu Palace. There hadn't been many opportunities for Yi Fushan to cultivate in peace, so naturally, he did not want to bother with the thought of the challenge. He did not know who Jing Yang was, and it did not matter if he was a prodigy. None of this had anything to do with Yi Fushan. Defeating Jing Yang would only draw more attention to himself and would have no benefit for him. It might even bring about more problems. The students of the School of the Flirting Star continued to throw insults at Yi Fushan, but he paid them no attention. He was not listening to any of their comments. Unbeknownst to him, Yi Fushan broke through another plane while he cultivated silently. He was now a three-starred glory plane in both martial and divination arts. During his silent cultivation, he was also able to learn a large number of new spells. Yi Fushan was attempting a battle tactic which was a combination of martial and divination arts in his dorm. He specialized in the sorcery of different elements, so if he was able to incorporate his powerful martial arts abilities into his sorcery, his combat would be able to reach new levels. Yu Sheng watched him from the side. He said to Yi Fushan, "Of the seven elements, you have cultivated in all of them with corresponding spells, all except for the element of water." Although Yi Fushan could perceive all elements, he did not have a water elemental life spirit, so his gift in this element was on the weaker side. For the time being, he did not have the ability to cultivate the element of water. Other than that, he was at the highest level of cultivation in all of the other elements. His natal spirit was the world tree, which was wood elemental. He had already begun to cultivate in this element even though he knew that there was a chance that the natal spirit would never be released in front of others. "These are all spells chosen by me. There's no harm in learning more." Yi Fushan smiled and said, "I have to step out and take care of some things so I might not make it back tonight. Work hard on cultivating and quickly make it to the four-starred glory plane." "Okay, I should be getting there," nodded Yu Sheng. His journey in cultivation was no easier than that of Yi Fushan. Yi Fushan mounted the Black Wind Eagle and was out of Donghai Academy. The Luo Palace was a palace in the city of Donghai. It was rumored that the master of the palace, Lord Luo, was a distant relative of the king of the Nandu Nation. Other rumors had it that he was in the good graces of the imperial family, and was therefore named Lord. Regardless of the reason, he was the only person in all of the city of Donghai to be given such a title. Naturally, his status was everything but that of the ordinary. The Luo Palace was extremely dignified, and was a true family of power. There was a young man standing in front of the Luo Palace. It was Yi Fushan. Outside the doors of the palace, people were busily scurrying around. The building was well decorated and there was a festive atmosphere in the air. Yi Fushan knew that the master of the palace was having a birthday celebration. However, none of that mattered to Yi Fushan. The only thing he cared about was Lord Luo. He was the only arcana plane healing sorcerer of the spirit element in all of Donghai City. He was the person that Tang Lan had refused to tell him about. Investigating this was the only thing Yi Fushan did outside of cultivation. He was always thinking about Hua Feng Liu's injuries. Yi Fushan did not understand why Tang Lan had been so sure Lord Luo would refuse to help. He was not completely confident that he could get Lord Luo to agree to help heal Hua Feng Liu, but he knew that he couldn't just sit around and do nothing. He found out that Lord Luo lived an isolated life and cared a lot about his reputation. Every year on his birthday he would hold an extravagant celebration. Yi Fushan wanted to find out exactly what kind of person he was, and see if there was a chance to persuade him to help Hua Feng Liu. Yi Fushan owed this to Hua Feng Liu. This was also what he had promised to a Jiu. It did not matter if he succeeded, he had to give it all he had. The steward noticed Yi Fushan, a handsome young man, he thought. With a smile, he asked, "Is there something I can help you with, young master?" "May I ask if there will be dancing and music entertainment at Lord Luo's birthday celebration? I specialize in performing the gun. If possible, I would like to play for Lord Luo at his birthday celebration," said Yi Fushan. The steward smiled and replied, "The palace does not lack a gun player. I am sure that I am more capable than your present personnel." Yi Fushan continued, "If it's really not possible, then are you guys lacking in the errand boy department?" The steward looked at Yi Fushan confused. The young man had an aura of elegance, and was obviously not an errand boy. "Young master, why are you so adamant on entering the palace?" asked the steward. His eyes squinted with suspicion. The steward was a clever man. "I just want to witness the extravagance for myself," Yi Fushan said calmly, keeping his composure. "The palace has no shortage of gun players or errand boys," the steward said, rejecting Yi Fushan. Although one teenager couldn't do much harm, he could not simply grant him access to the palace. "Hey!" At that moment, Someone from behind them called out in surprise. Yi Fushan turned around and was met with two beautiful girls. The girl walking in front was especially beautiful. Yi Fushan had met both of these girls aboard the ship on his way to the city of Donghai. "It's you?" the girl in front asked in surprise. She had thought that they were passing strangers, never to meet again. She would never have expected to run into him again, much less at a place like this. "Young Miss Lin Zhu, is he a friend of yours?" asked the steward. "Could the young man have come for the young miss?" "It couldn't be. She arrived only yesterday as a guest of the palace." "Yes," Lin Zhu nodded. She smiled at Yi Fushan. "What are you doing here?" "The young master says he is a gen player and wants to perform during Lord Luo's celebration," said the steward. Since he was a friend of Lin Zhu, there was no way he could say that Yi Fushan came to be an errand boy. "Yeah," Yi Fushan agreed. "Why don't we give him a chance?" Lin Zhu asked the steward. The steward smiled helplessly but nodded anyway. "Since young miss has spoken, then I guess we can give him a chance. Young master, this way please." The group walked into the palace. Lin Zhu and Zhao He were on either side of Yi Fushan. Lin Zhu asked, "Didn't you say you were coming to Donghai City to attend school? Why do you want to be a gun player at the palace?"
"That's right. I'm attending Donghai Academy now. I just wanted to come explore the palace and see what it's like," replied Yi Fushan with a smile.
"You're lying," Zhao He snickered. "When you arrived in Donghai City, the spring quarter exams were already over. How could you have gotten into the academy already?" "Are you making things up to attract Lin Zhu's attention?"
"Stop with the nonsense, Zhao He," said Lin Zhu while trying to suppress a smile. While this was going on, they failed to notice Yi Fushan shrugging his shoulders in defeat. He felt helpless. Every time he told the truth, nobody was willing to believe him.
"Oh right, what are you doing here? Do you live in the Luo Palace?" Yi Fushan asked curiously. Lin Zhu shook her head.
"The elders of my family know Lord Luo, so the younger generation of the family is also familiar with him. I came this time to visit him. I can introduce some people to you."
"I see," Yi Fushan nodded slightly. It looked like Lin Zhu was the young miss of a noble family. It was no wonder that her every gesture and way of speech flowed with such elegance. "What kind of person is Lord Luo?" Yi Fushan asked her in a low voice. Tang Lan had said that it was impossible for Lord Luo to agree to help. If it was simply because of his proud and aloof personality, then it was not a problem. But if it was because Lord Luo and Hua Fengliu had some sort of rivalry going on, then maybe it really was impossible to persuade him to help. "Stern, but kind."
"It really depends on the situation," smiled Lin Zhu. The group arrived in the garden area. There was a person playing on the gun, as well as dancers. They seemed to be rehearsing for tonight's performance. It was obvious that they would not want to make any mistakes at Lord Luo's birthday celebration. It was best to prepare beforehand. The steward went to whisper to the gun player, then turned to Yi Fushan. "Would you like to give it a go?"
"Sure," nodded Yi Fushan. The gun player got up and gave his seat to Yi Fushan. When Yi Fushan's fingers finally met with the chords of the gun, the aura around him shifted. It was now quiet and peaceful. A touch of elegance added onto his already outstanding looks. His long fingers flew over the chords, strumming them as he moved. The sound of the gun played and the original gun player's expression darkened. The music played softly, and everyone was being drawn in.
"That's enough. I admit defeat." The gun player smiled bitterly and shook his head. Being able to create a certain mood was an important part of playing the instrument. Even though Yi Fushan was young, he was able to play as if he had years of experience. Yi Fushan played at a level that he could not reach. However, the gun player had no idea that Yi Fushan was a musical sorcerer, and was able to surpass ordinary gun players like himself even without musical spells. "If it's like this, then young master, you should stay here today and learn the pieces you need to play tomorrow. How does that sound?" asked the steward.
"All right, thank you." Yi Fushan smiled.
"Lin Zhu, what are you doing here?"
At that moment, a group of youths approached from afar.
"We were just looking for you. What brings you here to observe the rehearsal?" asked one of the youths in the group.
The group Yi Fushan was standing in all turned their heads towards the voices. All of them had a magnificent aura around them. They must all either be from prominent families or the Luo Palace. "My friend is playing the gun here,
so I came to check it out," explained Lin Zhu. "Your friend?" One of them looked at Yi Fushan. "Yeah, he's a Gen player. He wants to play at tomorrow's birthday celebration," nodded Lin Zhu. "Oh, I see." One of the youths lost interest as soon as he heard Gen player. He continued, "Lin Zhu, let's go. Someone is coming." "Okay," nodded Lin Zhu. She turned to give Yi Fushan a quick wave goodbye. Yi Fushan returned the gesture with a smile. "Who is it?" Lin Zhu asked the group of youths as they walked away from Yi Fushan. "Zhu Miu," replied one of them. Lin Zhu's eyes lit up. She heard that Zhu Miu was already a five-starred glory plane conjurer. He was highly gifted just as his master had been years ago. "Oh right, Lin Zhu, how did you end up making friends with a Gen player?" asked a young woman in the group. "We met once by chance," she answered. "Is it because of his good looks?" teased the young woman. Lin Zhu smiled but did not reply. Yi Fushan was handsome, even more so when he was playing his instrument, but it was unfortunate that he was a American player. In addition, he seemed to be boastful and a liar, but Lin Zhu thought that it might be because he was too prideful. Lin Zhu did not invite Yi Fushan to join the group, nor did she introduce him to them. Yi Fushan knew that a Gen player like himself did not belong in a group with the nobles. However, they had only been strangers to begin with, so Yi Fushan really did not mind. Besides, he had not entered the palace to get to know that group of youths anyway. Chapter 54, Banquet in the Luo Palace. All the music and dances for the birthday banquet of Lord Luo had been settled, and the musician left after he had taught Yi Fushan the songs he was assigned to play. The steward also repeatedly told him some do's and don'ts for the next day. Yi Fushan was left in the palace to rehearse with a group of girls. Their figures and facial features were all top-notch, especially the leader. She was about 18 years old, extraordinarily sexy, but with a face full of the youthfulness of a younger girl. When she was dancing in that dress made of chiffon, it was possible for any man to fall in love with her. Yi Fushan kept his head low while playing the song. A sweet and charming voice suddenly spoke. "Why don't you raise your head?" A gorgeous face soon appeared in front of him. He smiled and replied, "You are so charming that once I see you, I feel distracted." "You do know how to compliment girls," she chuckled. Her skirt swung onto the gun. "Just come and join us." She started dancing again and seemed to be luring him intentionally. Most of the musicians were just old men, so she was surprised that the assigned musician this time was such a young and pretty boy. "Sorry miss, I have a girlfriend," Yi Fushan smiled at her. The girl was dumbfounded for a moment, then started chuckling again along with the girls around her. "What are you talking about? Remember, my name is Yun Ru, and in the future, I will marry a very powerful cultivator." "You are too young to pique my interest," Yun Ru made fun of him. "Nice to meet you. I'm Yi Fushan," he replied, and then the rehearsal continued. They told Yi Fushan that tomorrow, at the birthday banquet of Lord Luo, there would be many influential people of the city of Donghai attending. However, these girls didn't have any further information. In this continent, the talents of cultivation determined everything. Even a gorgeous girl who was born to a mundane family could not gain much advantage from her beauty. She might marry a powerful cultivator, but most likely, she'd end up a concubine rather than a wife. Even worse, since powerful cultivators tended to look for younger women, affairs would become an inevitable fate on the man's side of the marriage as time went by. The next day, the Luo Palace became boisterous in the morning. A lot of servants were busy preparing for the banquet and hosting the visitors. The rehearsals kept going. After lunch, there started to be more and more visitors crowding into the banquet room. Yi Fushan and the girls were already in place. The banquet was opulent. The center spot was reserved for Lord Luo, the guest of honor, as he was the one being celebrated. Then, there were seats arranged in rows on both sides of Lord Luo's spot. Apparently, the people who were seated closer to Lord Luo were of higher status in this city. There was a broad space between these two rows, and behind the seats, there was a stage with a golden carpet. That was where Yi Fushan and the girls were to perform. It was designed to liven up the banquet without distracting the guests. Before the guests were seated, the show had already started. The whole room was filled with laughter. Lin Zhu and Zhao He were among the first group of people entering the room. While they were getting ushered into their seats, Lin Zi noticed Yi Fushan and smiled at him. Such a pity that you're rarely attracted to a boy, and the one you pick is only a musician, Zhao He joked. Lin Zi gave her a stare. Stop that. A pretty handsome boy came to them and asked with a smile, what are you talking about?
Nothing, Mr. Luo.
Lin Zi shook her head. Zhu, people told me that you brought that musician to this place. Is he your friend? The boy asked. We've met twice. He told me that he wanted to come here and broaden his horizons, so I did him a favor. You're fine with that, aren't you? Lin Zi answered. It's okay. In fact, if he wants to, he can stay here as long as he wants. The boy was still laughing. Okay, I'll ask him after the banquet is over, Lin Zi said. Sure, see you later. The boy left. Zhao He whispered to Zhu, young Lord Luo seemed to be attracted to you, girl. I already told you to stop. Lin Zi felt awkward. I'm serious. I know he doesn't look as cute as Yi Fushan, but what about his status? Zhao He didn't want to stop. Lin Zi gave up. She knew that this girl liked to joke. Young girls had all kinds of fantasies. Apparently, Yi Fushan did not understand what they were thinking at all. Suddenly, someone entered the room, walking with majestic steps. He was apparently of high status in this place. People stopped chatting and greeted him. Happy birthday, Lord Luo. Yi Fushan also raised his head and looked at Lord Luo. He had an absolutely commanding and dignified appearance. Long time no see, Lord Luo. You actually look younger than the last time we met, someone walked up to him and said. Lord Luo, happy birthday from the Lin family. People started to queue up to send birthday congratulations. Lord Luo, happy birthday from the Xia family. A bright and clear voice sounded. I appreciate it, Lord Xia. Lord Luo replied with a smile. The title of Lord Luo was merely conferred without substantial authority. In fact, Xia Feng, the head of the Xia family, was the most powerful man in this city. Still, there were some other people almost equally dignified in this city, such as the head of the Nandu family, the supervisors of schools at Donghai Academy, and a few others. Behind Xia Feng, there was a young man who bowed slightly to Lord Luo. Greetings, Lord Luo. I'm Xia Fan. Mr. Xia Fan, you have grown up, Lord Luo complimented. Don't praise him, Lord Luo. He has been dawdling all the time. With your compliment, I'm afraid it's going to be worse, Xia Feng joked. Coincidentally, Yi Fushan raised his head at this moment, and soon noticed Xia Fan. The moment he saw Xia Fan, he gave him an icy glare. After Xia Feng and Xia Fan were seated, Xia Fan started enjoying the show. When he saw Yun Ru, he felt very attracted to this beautiful girl. However, soon he noticed that Yi Fushan was sitting behind her, playing. He frowned and felt very confused. How could Yi Fushan be here? How had he survived after jumping into the canyon? Had the ferocious snow ape just let him go? Yi Fushan was also looking at Xia Fan. They stared at each other, and Yi Fushan perceived the contempt in Xia Fan's eyes. Xia Fan had believed Yi Fushan was just a nobody, someone that Xia Fan did not care was alive or dead. Xia Fan was the young lord of Donghai province. He could entirely ignore Yi Fushan due to their vast gap in status. He knew that Hua Fengliu, the only patron of Yi Fushan, was now crippled. The only thing he felt frustrated about was that his uncle had died at the hands of the snow ape in that fight. Who are you looking at? Xia Feng asked. Nothing. I just saw someone interesting, Xia Fan responded. It was extremely interesting that the disciple of the Gun Devil was now serving in this room as a musician. Yi Fushan became peaceful and kept playing. He wasn't worried about running into Xia Fan at this place. He was already a student of Donghai Academy, so no one would be allowed to try to kill him this time, no matter how powerful they were. Happy birthday from the Nandu family, another congratulation came. Lord Luo looked at the person approaching and started laughing. Long time no see, Mr. Nandu. There were two men from the Nandu family. One was middle-aged, and one was young. They were Nandu Wenshan and his son, Nandu Kai. They had come here on behalf of the Nandu family. Since they were the leaders of the Nandu family, attending this banquet represented the respect they held for Lord Luo. Long time no see, Lord Luo, Nandu Wenshan replied. Lord Luo ushered these two into the seats closest to himself. So,
Wenshan, you do come here, another voice said, and Nandu Wenshan stood up from his seat to greet the new group of people that had just entered the room. Why did you come here together? Nandu Wenshan laughed. We met each other on the way here. One of them had a complexion as clear as jade. He was casually dressed for this banquet, but it was obvious that he was not someone common. The other one was an old man, but still in good shape. He laughed at Lord Luo and greeted him. I am here on behalf of Donghai Academy. Thanks so much, Lord Luo replied with his body slightly bowed down. He then ushered these two men into their seats, also the ones closest to him. This group of people was now having a conversation. They were among the most influential people in the city. Mr. Art Saint has been friends with Lord Luo for a long time. He has attended his birthday banquet every year. It's said that Mr. Art Saint has reached a higher plane than he was in last year. The person who is with him actually runs the School of the Emperor Star at Donghai Academy. I believe the young man behind him must be Zhu Mu. He is already a 5-star glory plane invoker. A true genius. People say that Art Saint is trying to form a political marriage between Zhu Mu and the daughter of the Nandu family. I think Art Song is trying to make up for his mistakes of the past. I'm afraid that this job is not going to be easy. The princess of the Nandu family is supremely gorgeous, talented, and so treasured by the Nandu family that they don't want to trade her for political interest. People were whispering to each other. They lowered their voices to avoid being heard, but Yi Fushan still learned a lot of information from all the talk. He looked at the middle-aged man with the bright complexion and realized that this man was Art Saint, who had destroyed Hua Fengliu's natal spirit. He soon understood why Tang Lan had told him it would be impossible to ask for help from Lord Luo. Lord Luo was longtime friends with Hua Fengliu's nemesis. He felt upset, as it seemed that his attempt to get help was all in vain. However, he had obtained a lot of information about the political situation in the city of Donghai. He was still curious about the relationship between Hua Jiyu and the representative of the Nandu family. Chapter 55, White Feather Garments. Upon the arrival of the guests, the celebration began. Drinks were exchanged and the sound of laughter and conversation filled the air. The older partygoers formed their own small circle while the younger partygoers did the same. Other than presenting their gifts and exchanging words of common courtesy, everyone was discussing interesting new happenings within the city of Donghai. Somewhere along the line, someone brought up the Tropic of Qingzhou City. I heard that the historical remains of that person were discovered in the city of Qingzhou, and that you even went to investigate personally. Is that true, Xia Fan? Someone asked with their sight set on Xia Fan. By that person they obviously meant Emperor Yi Qing, but because he was a taboo character in the divine prefectures of the East Sea, it would be inappropriate to use his name in a public place such as this. It is true indeed. However, a demon king, or perhaps even higher-leveled snow ape demon stood guard there and we were unable to enter. My younger brother even lost his life at the hands of that monster, said Xia Feng. What Chief Xia Feng said is true. I wanted to take part in it like every else and traveled to Qingzhou City. Indeed, no one was able to get close to the historical site. I heard that the path was blocked by demons and monsters, said Lin Zhu's father. Many people nodded in agreement. Many powerful individuals have sent their people to Qingzhou, but they all returned with no results. If really was a demon of higher level than a demon king, then forget about us. Probably even the Nandu nation wouldn't be able to do anything about it, someone sighed. Hearing their words, Yi Fushan felt a twinge of sadness. If the snow ape had not refused to leave the mountains, then Yi Fushan would not have to beware of his every move in Donghai City. He would have been able to do whatever he pleased, even in the Nandu nation. Yi Fushan debated whether or not he should find time to head back to Mount Danyao to persuade the snow ape to leave with him. Brother Lin, your daughter, Linza, should be about 16 years old now, right? She's getting more beautiful by the day, said Lord Luo. His eyes drifted to Lin Zhu in the crowd. Her beautiful eyes contained a hint of timidness. Thank you for your compliment, Lord Luo, said Lin Zhu's father. Has she been betrothed? Asked Lord Luo. Not yet, but she is still young. She is still focusing all her attention on cultivation. There's no hurry. answered her father. That is true, but looking around this venue, there are many worthy young men.
It couldn't hurt to meet them, chuckled Lord Luo.
Speaking of worthy young men, I heard that the Art Saint's disciple, Zhu Miu, is already in the five-starred glory plane, Lin Zhu's father said. He looked over at Zhu Miu, who stood behind the Art Saint.
It's all thanks to Master's guidance.
Zhu Miu smiled lightly in response. Nandu Kai beside Nandu Wenshan does not pale in comparison to Zhu Miu, the Art Saint said modestly as he looked at Nandu Wenshan. Nandu Kai is slightly older and his gift is not half bad, but in comparison with Zhu Miu, he is still lacking.
He will need to work harder, said Nandu Wenshan.
How is she doing? The Art Saint asked suddenly. Nandu Wenshan was stunned, but then shook his head with a bitter smile and said, my younger sister is still the same. I heard that her daughter is back and is an exceptional person.
Zhu Miu keeps pestering me to let them meet, the Art Saint continued to speak.
Everyone exchanged a look. Indeed, the Art Saint was trying to set up his disciple with the young Miss of the Nandu family. Shockingly, he did not seem to care that she was the Gen Devil's daughter. It was probably a love someone and love everything about them type of situation. After all, the Art Saint had always been madly in love with that person.
It is true, Hua Jiu is exceptional. She is now practicing cultivation at the School of the Emperor Star within Donghai Academy. Nandu Wenshan smiled. Upon hearing this exchange, his heart was no longer calm.
The Art Saint wanted to set up his disciple with Hua Jiu. In addition, it seemed that Nandu Wenshan was the older brother of Master's wife, which would make him Hua Jiu's uncle. Hua Jiu's gifts are top-notch within the Emperor Star School. It would be hard to find a person who could compare with her in all of Donghai Academy, said an elder of the School of the Emperor Star. Since Hua Jiu was a student of his school, he knew quite a bit about her.
You guys are all complimenting her.
It makes me want to meet the young miss of the Nandu family. Lord Luo laughed. Hua Jiu? Xia Fan's lips twitched into a wicked smile. His eyes landed on Yi Fushan, who was playing the gun. In the city of Qingzhou, he had seen Hua Jiu and Yi Fushan together by the lake. The relationship between the two did not seem like that of ordinary friends. Xia Fan wondered what would happen if the Nandu family found out the ambiguous relationship between Hua Jiu and Yi Fushan. Just the thought of this brought a smile to Xia Fan's face.
Of course, there were other ways to crush Yi Fushan. He did not have to do it this way.
If he were to expose their relationship in a setting like this, he might offend the Nandu family. After all, they were a big, powerful family, and cared a lot about their reputation. Hua Jiu was also the apple of their eyes. They would not permit anyone to try to drag her through the mud. Yi Fushan felt that something was amiss and lifted his head to look at Xia Fan. Right now, everyone was talking about Hua Jiu, so Yi Fushan knew immediately what Xia Fan might have been thinking. He could not help but raise his eyebrows at Xia Fan. As a person, Xia Fan was sinister and treacherous, a truly despicable person. Yi Fushan had gotten a taste of this back in the city of Qingzhou. When the chance comes, I shall have Hua Jiu come to pay respect to you, Lord Luo. Nandu Wenshan smiled at Lord Luo's words. You should stop talking about Hua Jiu now. Since we have so many talented young people gathered here today, and since Lord Luo is in such a good mood, why don't we have the youngster perform?
That's right. This would be the perfect opportunity to catch a glimpse at all the young talent in the city of Donghai, someone chimed in.
This piqued Lord Luo's interest as well. Thus, he went on to say, then, let's have any youngsters willing to perform show off their skills in front of us elders. There shall be hefty rewards for the best performances. Lin Zhu, how about you go first? Lord Luo set his sight on Lin Zhu. She blinked a couple times then nodded with a smile. With light steps, she carried herself to the middle of the crowd. Lord Luo, I hope you will enjoy my lacking performance. After she spoke, water spiritual qi began to gather around her. Her hands danced in the air, carrying the spiritual qi with her every movement. Slowly, the character for longevity formed in midair and floated towards Lord Luo. It only disappeared once it had reached him. Lin Zhu, you're already a three-starred glory plane sorcerer. How fast? That was very interesting, complimented Lord Luo.
Thank you for your compliments,
said Lin Zhu. She bowed to him and retreated into the crowd. A young man stepped up. "I will perform a sword dance for you, Lord Luo." He drew out the sword he carried on his person, and it began to dance through the air. With every slash of the sword, a stroke was left in the air. When the young man finished his performance, five words were left in midair: "May you achieve boundless eternity." "Nice." Many people applauded him. Following that, other youths continued to put on their performances to present their blessings and best wishes to Lord Luo. At the same time, they were able to put their talents on display. Their performances brightened up the atmosphere of the party venue. "Brother Hua, does your disciple not wish to perform?" someone asked the art saint. The art saint's surname was Hua, a different Hua from Hua Fengliu. "Go," commanded the art saint. "Yes, master," answered Zhu Miu. Stepping up, he held a pencil in his hand. Then, he laid out a large piece of paper on the bright golden yellow carpet. Zhu Miu bent down and began to draw. It's rare to see Zhu Miu in action. "We are also lucky to be able to witness the art saint's disciple in action," said one of the youths in the crowd. All the youngsters at the venue admired Zhu Miu. "I've never seen a conjurer in action before, so I don't know what it's like," said a young girl. Her eyes glowed in interest as she observed Zhu Miu. Zhu Miu drew with great speed. His movements were natural and graceful. Lord Luo complimented, "Brother Hua, your disciple has such a grand aura for a person of his age." "That's true," everyone else agreed. Even Yun Ren and her group of dancers tried to look on as they danced. Yi Fushan was also aware of all the happenings, despite playing with his head down. He was thinking to himself, Hua Fengliu and the art saint were old rivals, not only in power, but also in love. To be able to take mistress away from someone like the art saint, Yi Fushan could only imagine how charming Hua Fengliu must have been in the past. If Hua Fengliu did not have his powers disabled, then he probably could have been like admired and respected like the art saint. To have ended up in his situation, Yi Fushan felt really bad for Hua Fengliu. Zhu Miu drew as Yi Fushan played the Gun. One was the disciple of the art saint, one was the disciple of the Gun devil. However, everyone's focus was on Zhu Miu. Finally, Zhu Miu's work was complete. A fire phoenix escaped from the artwork and circled the skies above. Covered in the flames, it let out a screech. Then, it landed by Lord Luo's side and began to dance for him. "Bravo. Wonderful. The phoenix is a symbol of success. What a wonderful omen. We wouldn't have expected anything less of the young art saint." Everyone was full of praise for Zhu Miu. Even Lord Luo gave him a look and smile of approval. He said, "You shall be rewarded." "Thank you, my lord." Zhu Miu bowed and then returned to his spot by his master. "Watching Zhu Miu, I was reminded of a person. A couple days ago, Nanduku paid a visit to the Gun Gardens and saw Hua Fengliu," said Nandu Wenshan. In a split second, he had captured everyone's attention. The Gun devil was back in the city of Donghai. However, he's handicapped now and is being protected by Tang Lan. "He even took in a disciple," Nandu Wenshan elaborated. "Handicapped?" Everyone was shocked. Even the art saint was surprised. "What a shame." "Why is it a shame?" "Even if he weren't handicapped, he wouldn't dare show his face in front of you, art saint," someone laughed. "That's right." In the past, Hua Fengliu had no understanding of his own capabilities and brought the humiliation onto himself. Who would have thought he would still have the nerve to come back after becoming disabled? Would he even be able to groom the disciple he took in? If his disciple met with Zhu Miu, he would probably have to walk in the other direction. Another person mocked Hua Fengliu. "He can only live under someone else's protection now. Why is he even thinking about anything else?" People began to speak up against Hua Fengliu. All their words were meant to suck up to the art saint. Xia Fan watched Yi Fushan. He could not wait to see how long it would take for Yi Fushan to explode in anger. Just as everyone was enjoying their time making fun of Hua Fengliu, they were interrupted by the sounds of the Gun. The style has shifted. The once soft notes were getting louder and faster as well. Slowly, Yunra and the other dancers became influenced by the music. The women began to dance their hearts away. Their long dresses flowed with their movements. They all looked like goddesses. Under the influence of the music, The youngsters got more excited and the elders were in an even better mood now. The atmosphere of the entire party venue was pushed to the highest point. "What piece is this?" asked the art saint. His eyes drifted toward Yi Fushan. Not only him, but the other high authority figures as well felt something amiss. Their emotions were being controlled by the music. The youths at the party were getting agitated and the dancers on stage looked like they were unable to pull themselves away from the music. Behind the stage, a young man was playing his instrument silently. He seemed to be in a world of his own. His looks could be said to be one of the best amongst the younger partygoers. When he played, he released a mystical force that was incorporated into his music. "The melody of the white feather's garment. Who are you?" The art saint's gaze sharpened and his utterance interrupted the music. Many people began to wake up from their previous trance. They all stared at the young gin player in shock. They watched as the young man lifted his head slowly. His eyes were clear and clean with no sense of lowliness. Looking towards Lord Luo, he spoke. "I am the gin devil's disciple, Yi Fushan. I am here to convey blessings in place of my master with a single piece. The melody of the white feather's garment. Chapter 56. Please, bring it on." The boy was not talking loudly, but his voice was still rather firm. Suddenly, the banquet was silenced. "Yi Fushan, disciple of the Ken Devil, hereby delivers happy birthday to Lord Luo with white feather garments. On behalf of my master." People were surprised that this young musician was the disciple of the Kin Devil. The white feather garments had totally taken over their mind, which indicated that there was strong mental power contained in that music spell. The power was especially demonstrated by the young men and women who started dancing along. If not for the interruption from the art saint, they would still be possessed by the mental power in that song. Yun Renau looked at Yi Fushan with absolute surprise. This seemingly careless boy was actually quite powerful. The song he just played, "The Melody of White Feather Garments," was one of the most renowned royal waltzes. It was said that if this song was played by a powerful sorcerer that specialized in music spells, people listening to it would soon be trapped into a world of illusion. Lin Zhu and Zhao He were also looking at him. They felt shocked that this ordinary young musician was in fact the disciple of the famous Kin Devil. So, was he a musical sorcerer? "Yi Fushan, where did I hear this name before?" Some students of Donghai Academy were mumbling, because this name rang a bell for them. Soon, they realized who he was, and wondered if this boy was the same person who recently became famous in Donghai Academy. Art Saint and Lord Luo were both staring at Yi Fushan, feeling confused. They never anticipated that the disciple of the Ken Devil would show up in this banquet as the musician. If Nandu Wenshan had not mentioned the Ken Devil, or people had not satirized him, this boy would still be playing peacefully. Nandu Wenshan heard from Nandu Ku that the Ken Devil had high expectations for this disciple. He realized the reason. According to the vibe of this boy, he was almost the younger version of Ken Devil. Now, silence haunted the place. It was just too dramatic for the disciple of the Ken Devil to show up in this situation. Xia Fan was sneering at Yi Fushan. He did not believe that Yi Fushan actually dared to announce his identity under these circumstances. Meanwhile, Yi Fushan stood up and bowed slightly to the person running the School of Emperor Star in Donghai Academy. "Greetings, Professor," from Yi Fushan, "the School of Finance Star." "You are a student of that school?" The supervisor was surprised about the fact that the disciple of the Ken Devil was currently studying at the School of Finance Star. Obviously, he did not pay much attention to this boy, who had recently become rather famous in Donghai Academy. "I was admitted recently." Yi Fushan took out the name tag from his pocket. The supervisor from the School of Emperor Star nodded slightly, without saying anything. At that moment, Xia Fan's face turned very pale. He could not believe that Yi Fushan had been admitted to Donghai Academy. With his identity as a Donghai Academy student, and that this was a public birthday banquet, it would be difficult to do anything to him. Even though the supervisor from the School of Emperor Star seemed not to like Yi Fushan, as long as he was a student in Donghai Academy, people could hardly be harsh to him. Lin Zhu was looking at Yi Fushan, totally distracted. She remembered that Yi Fushan used to tell her that he was studying at Donghai Academy. At that time, She believed that he was bragging, but it seemed that he was actually telling the truth. In fact, she should not be blamed. She met Yi Fushan on a ship to this city, and at that time, the spring term entry test had ended. That was why she and Zhao He both believed Yi Fushan was bragging. So, there remained only one possibility for Yi Fushan to enter Donghai Academy. Yi Fushan was well appreciated by someone running the School of Finance star, so a rare exception was made for him. She totally realized what it meant. Yi Fushan was possibly much more talented than other students in Donghai Academy. Other people were also confused about this admission. Donghai Academy was the best school in this province, and Yi Fushan was given an exception soon after he arrived. Zhu Miu, the disciple of Art Saint, was well known for his extraordinary talents. However, now, the disciple of the Ken Devil stepped out and shocked the whole audience with white feather garments, which indicated that he was also unusual. Things were getting interesting. "That's a good song. How's your master doing?" Lord Luo asked him, his voice monotone. Yi Fushan played that song as a birthday gift, so he must not lose his politeness in this situation. "My professor was set up by a villain and has been crippled for a while. Now he is peacefully living in his own garden, unbothered by the mess happening outside." Yi Fushan sounded peaceful. However, Xia Fan felt mad. He had just been referred to as a villain. People looked at him. This youth said only what was necessary. He told them that Kin Devil was now living on his own, crippled, and did not care about that what was going on outside. This speech successfully prevented further trouble for his professor. "Today, I was going to play the song peacefully to entertain the guests here, and did not intend to interrupt the fun going on. However, so many people started to insult Mr. Huafengliu." He glanced at the audience and kept talking. "I am not a great student, but still, I have dignity. So does my professor. I cannot act like nothing is going on when people are insulting my professor. I know there are a lot of talented young men in this place who have some negative impressions of him. I will accept any challenge if you believe I am not being appropriate." He paused for a second, then stared at those who insulted Huafengliu. "Please, bring it on." He was only 16 years old, and now there were so many big chiefs of this city sitting in the room. However, the way he talked was neither humble nor pushy. Every word from his mouth was firm and solid. The talented young men were showing off their achievements and complimenting each other. However, suddenly, someone who had been silent announced that he would challenge any one of them. How dramatic was this? The Kin Devil definitely deserved a disciple with such guts. People did not know what to say. The girls who used to talk with him felt that, in the past, they did not know him at all. The true self he hid was so different. Those who insulted the Ken Devil now looked embarrassed. This boy was acting polite, yet had a firm will. They were totally overshadowed by his personality, not to mention being challenged. "What plane are you on, boy?" Lord Luo asked, to err on the side of caution. If he was too powerful, it would be better for the people challenged to just ignore him rather than having their SS kicked. "Three-star glory plane it is," Yi Fushan replied peacefully. Lord Luo did not say anything, but started looking at the young men in this room. Three-star glory plane was impressive for a boy his age, but not too rare for other young men attending the banquet. "I accept your challenge." Someone stood up from his seat. It was the swordsman who responded. He was in the same plane as Yi Fushan, a three-star glory plane swordsman. "Okay, just show us your best. You don't have to worry about damaging this place at all," Lord Luo told them. There were so many powerful people in this place that the audience would be well protected from the fight. "Understood." The swordsman unsheathed his weapon and stepped toward Yi Fushan. Yi Fushan went back to his gun and slowly sat down. The girls already evacuated the place for him. Since someone was insulting the Kin Devil, he should absolutely defeat those people with the techniques he inherited from Huafengliu, which were the music spells. He started playing, and suddenly the room was full of a feeling of desolation. Some of the people soon felt as if they were brought to a state of illusion, where they were left alone in a deep woods in a mountain. That is a music spell. Some powerful people soon recognized what it was. The rainbow and feather garments he played were not injected with much mental power, so the effect was not truly strong. But since Yi Fushan was being serious this time, the song was played with immense power of mental control. The swordsman also initiated his attack. He charged as fast as thunder toward Yi Fushan. However, there was a continuous sound. It pierced through his eardrum with a magical power, and he was also drawn into the illusion. Now, he saw himself charging toward Yi Fushan, but in the background was a cliff. He realized he had been mentally attacked. He soon ignited his blade with the fire element power he possessed. He jumped off into the air and came down with authority. His hands were holding the sword firmly, and the blade was pointed exactly at Yi Fushan's forehead. Yi Fushan suddenly sped up his fingers. His fingers were now insanely fast, and there was a dragon vaguely roaring in the song. Soon, he swung his hand towards his opponent, and the swordsman saw a dragon flying right at him. The dragon was not hurt by the blade at all, and totally engulfed his body in a second. In reality, people saw the swordsman suddenly stop his attack. He looked painful and desperate, and soon after, he fell onto the ground, severely injured. Yi Fushan finished the last note of his song, and said peacefully, "You all insult my professor but can only train disciples at this level?" Chapter 57, The Battle of the Disciples. Yi Fushan's words acted as a slap to the face. The people who had previously insulted Hua Fengliu were now fuming, their expressions dark. It was a palace celebration and the art saint was present. They had simply wanted to get on his good side by badmouthing his rival. They had never expected for the Ken Devil's exceptionally gifted disciple to appear with a challenge. The young man sitting behind the Ken had clean, carefree eyes. Yunra and the other dancers stared at his back with infatuation. It turned out that the young Ken player was capable of shining so bright. Lin Zhu and Zhao He could also feel Yi Fushan's excellence. They were acquainted with the young man he had just defeated. The young man's skills were not lacking at all, but he was still defeated instantly by Yi Fushan's musical spells. It was easy to see just how powerful Yi Fushan was. Lin Zhu thought, if it had been her up against him, the results would probably be the same. The venue fell into silence once again. Even though it was a simple challenge and did not seem to symbolize anything, the other youths knew better than to step up on a whim. Musical spells attacked the spirit and were extremely forceful. The young swordsman Yi Fushan had just defeated was also a three-starred glory plane sorcerer, so his spirit was pretty strong. But he was injured by Yi Fushan's musical spell even though he had yet to put in full force. This meant that any martial or divination art cultivators below the three-starred glory plane should not even think about going up against Yi Fushan. If your spirit was not strong enough, you would be immediately defeated by his musical spells. It seems like the Ken Devil has a successor. Who else is willing to give it a go? Asked Lord Luo. His tone was still calm, but in his heart, he was very unhappy. Today was his birthday celebration, but his spotlight had been stolen by the Ken Devil's disciple. If Yi Fushan had been the disciple of a friend, it would have been better, but he was the disciple of the Ken Devil. Since Lord Luo was good friends with the art saint, it was only natural that he did not like Hua Fengliu very much. Plus, what Yi Fushan said before had offended many people, and all of these people were his guests. However, Yi Fushan had been frank about his intentions from the beginning, which made it hard to pick any problems with him. After all, the group of elders could not blatantly pick on a youngster. Therefore, the best solution was to have Yi Fushan be defeated by one of the young people present. "I'll go," someone uttered. From the crowd, an excited young man dressed in extravagant golden clothing came forth. His aura was remarkable. "That's Zhu King. He's a thunder and fire by elemental sorcerer in the four-starred glory plane," said someone in the crowd. Everyone looked at him with anticipation, especially the youngsters from the Wo Palace. The spirit of four-starred glory plane cultivators was slightly stronger and should be able to withstand Yi Fushan's musical attacks. As long as the musical spells had no effect, Yi Fushan was defeated. "Zhu King, four-starred glory plane sorcerer," Zhu King introduced himself to Yi Fushan. "Please," answered Yi Fushan, not losing his patience. As he invited Zhu King onto the makeshift battlefield, Yi Fushan lowered his head and his fingers began to stroke the chords once again, blocking out everyone else in his surroundings. The people frowned as they listened to him play. This time around, his music lacked the feeling from before. The notes seemed to be random, unable to form into a distinguishable piece. The demon flurry, a look of recognition was on the art saint's face. He was old rivals with Huafeng Liu and was therefore familiar with his attack pieces. The piece that Yi Fushan played before was the Kangshan Dragon Chant, and this was the Demon Flurry. What seemed to be a disorganized piece was actually very powerful to deal with. Thunder and fire elemental spiritual chi erupted from Zhu Qing and it flowed around him as it harmonized with his spirit. The notes of Yi Fushan's kin continued to enter his ears. Zhu Qing grew increasingly agitated. He was unable to focus his spirit and he felt himself lose control of the spiritual chi as he attempted to gather it for a spell. In sorcery, it was essential for one's spirit to accurately and efficiently gather spiritual chi, or else the spells would never succeed. The crowd began to take notice of the strange scene. Zhu Qing continued to gather large amounts of spiritual chi but had yet to be able to form a spell. The spiritual chi continued to revolve around Zhu Qing in a violent manner. What's happening? The people were curious. Yi Fushan's musical spell seemed to only be affecting one person. The invisible sound waves were all focused in Zhu Qing's direction. The onlookers could only hear random chords being played, but Zhu Qing was able to hear the spirit attacking piece of the demon flurry clearly. Zhu Qing remained in one spot. He looked terrible as the sweat ran down his face. Something was wrong with the atmosphere around him. The demon flurry did not attack directly, as the Kangshan Dragon Chant did. Instead, it obstructed the release of the subject's sorcery. This piece was a sorcerer's kryptonite. As Yi Fushan continued to play, it became increasingly difficult for Zhu Qing to focus his spirit. His will was weakening. This battle took such a large toll on him, like nothing he had ever experienced before. But at the same time, this was his first time going against a musical sorcerer. The results are clear. "That's enough," said the art saint. His calm voice managed to carry great force, interrupting the music once again. Yi Fushan took his hands off the kin, looking as calm as ever. It was as if he had just played any old piece. On the other hand, Zhu Qing, who was still standing, looked as pale as a ghost. His body was shaking lightly, and he glared at Yi Fushan with burning rage. Zhu Qing had never been so humiliated before. Was that really a battle? From beginning to end, Zhu Qing did not get a single opportunity to make his move. He was trapped by the music. If they had continued, his spirit would have been depleted. The art saint looked at Yi Fushan, who Huafeng Liu did not come back to Donghai City with his disciple as retirement plan. "Step down," ordered Lord Luo when he saw that Zhu Qing had no intention of moving from his position. Zhu Qing was unwilling, but because Lord Luo said so, he backed down. His legs shook weakly beneath him as he walked away. He began to wonder what would have happened if he gave up on gathering spiritual chi for a spell and chose to attack at close range instead. Zhu Qing regretted not trying. Yi Fushan remained seated and only stood when no one else came forward. To Lord Luo he said, "My deepest apologies for interrupting your birthday celebration. I only wished to punish these people for their disrespectful words towards my master. I will excuse myself now." "You already started your tantrum. Do you think you can just leave like this?" someone voiced coldly. Everyone turned their attention to the young man beside the art saint. Zhu Mu was shooting daggers at Yi Fushan with his eyes. The art saint disabled the Qin Devil years ago. Now, were their disciples going to recreate history? The youngsters in the crowd were excited. Only Zhu Mu could avenge them now. Yi Fushan's musical sorcery was able to restrain both martial and divination art cultivators. "You want to duel?" asked Yi Fushan. Zhu Mu, five-starred glory plane. "I'm on a higher level than you and initially had no plans of challenging you, but seeing how arrogant you are, I can only step up to the plate." "Don't say that I'm bullying you," warned Zhu Mu. Then he stepped up and stood opposite of Yi Fushan. Everyone had their eyes glued on the two young men. They sneered at Yi Fushan. If they had simply let him go, not only the people who badmouthed Huafeng Liu, but all the youngsters present as well, would have felt utterly humiliated. Now that Zhu Mu was going to make his move, the results were set. Lin Zi was also looking at the two young men. Yi Fushan's performance was very surprising, But his opponent this time was Zhu Mu. She really hoped that he would reject the challenge. Zhu Mu was at a higher level than Yi Fushan, and so, it would not be embarrassing for him to reject. Then, let's fight. Just as Lin Zhu was thinking, Yi Fushan had already spoken. He returned to his seat once more. Hua Fengli had his powers disabled by the Art Saint all those years ago, but Yi Fushan was still not powerful enough to get revenge. However, fighting the Art Saint's disciple was something he could manage. Yi Fushan sat down and the music started again. Zhu Mu bent down on the ground and drew with his hands. Spiritual qi gathered at his fingertips and was released to form a picture. It was a lifelike gossok. He heard the notes that Yi Fushan played but remained unaffected because he was a powerful five-starred glory plane cultivator. His spirit was strong and therefore unaffected. Zhu Qing continued to draw. Not long after, he completed the gossok and it soared through the sky and headed to attack Yi Fushan. Bystanders were shocked. Zhu Qing's skills as a conjurer were too powerful. The pace at which Yi Fushan played sped up. His fingers flew rapidly across the instruments. Every note attacked the gossok. This caused the gossok's body to break down piece by piece. But because it felt no pain, the gossok did not halt its attacks on Yi Fushan. After a while, only half of the gossok's body was left, but it still descended with talons ready to attack Yi Fushan. Yi Fushan continued to stroke at the cords and finally, the gossok's body broke apart completely. Simultaneously, Yi Fushan's kin broke apart as well. A gust of wind swept past. Yi Fushan's clothes and hair danced in the wind. Vulnerable. The people were stunned by what happened and began commenting on Yi Fushan's defeat. Zhu Mu was powerful indeed. Yi Fushan was defeated as soon as he stepped in. Yi Fushan was a musical sorcerer. How was he going to battle without a kin? Lin Zhu sighed. Yi Fushan was strong, but his opponent was the Art Saint's genius disciple. However, Yi Fushan was unfazed. He had a silent epiphany. He finally understood why Hua Fengli lost to the Art Saint. The creature created by Zhu Mu was unaffected by the sounds of the kin. After receiving multiple blows to its body, it continued to attack. It was all because it was lifeless, only controlled by the conjurer. Musical spells were able to restrain ordinary martial and divination art cultivators but were restrained by conjurers. It was also because of this that one blow from Zhu Mu, who was two levels higher than himself, destroyed his kin. Is this all you've got? Zhu Mu was throwing Yi Fushan's words back at him. Zhu Mu stood in place with great pride. Although I have master's guidance, I lack the gift and am still unable to learn the main points of musical sorcery, said Yi Fushan. And that's why musical sorcery is only my weakest link. Chapter 58, I'm a mage, but also a warrior. As soon as Yi Fushan stopped talking, the people in the banquet room stopped smiling. Moments before, Zhu Mu, the disciple of the Art Saint, had accepted Yi Fushan's challenge and even broke his gin. People were about to latch onto this chance and chastise Yi Fushan in order to retrieve their dignity. However, even before they began, Yi Fushan shocked them again with his overbearing statement. Musical sorcery was his worst talent. They had seen many people who were reluctant to admit defeat, but they now considered Yi Fushan even worse. Almost shameless, Yi Fushan defeated two young geniuses with music spells, and successfully intimidated a lot of others. However, now he claimed that musical sorcery was his weakest skill. He was intentionally humiliating the young men at the banquet, suggesting that they were too lame to even compete with his worst skill. It almost seemed that he forgot the fact that his gin had been broken within a second. The big chiefs in the room did not believe him either. He acted like his defeat had not happened. This was intolerable. Your instrument has been broken. How dare you keep talking like this? Show me what you got without your gin. Now, Zhu Qing was still mad that he did not get to beat up Yi Fushan. He was a four-star glory plane mage with double element talent, but he did not even get the chance to fight. This was something he felt very angry about. You are not good enough for me, Yi Fushan said peacefully while walking toward Zhu Mu, but Zhu Qing was not done. He stood up from his seat, and the spiritual qi around his body started to gather in a frenzy. Yi Fushan stopped walking and gave Zhu Qing a glance. He noticed that thunderbolts clashed around Zhu Qing, and rage was burning in his eyes. Zhu Qing believed his previous defeat only happened because his spell channeling had been interfered with by the music spell. Otherwise, Yi Fushan would have been doomed. Thunder spell, the thunder vortex. All the thunderbolts converged over his body, and Zhu Qing almost looked like Thor's incarnate. Piercing lights were centered in his palm, and its power would be tremendous. Yi Fushan was forced to act. He also reached out his hands, and suddenly, there were also thunderbolts converging into his palm. Soon, there was a whirl of thunder that formed a sphere in his right hand. I can do that too. Yi Fushan sounded peaceful. People were so shocked that two boys were channeling the same spell. Even though Yi Fushan was in the lower plane, the thunderbolts in his palm were actually more converged than those Zhu Qing's palm. It actually indicated that Yi Fushan possessed a higher level of control over this spell than Zhu Qing did. Zhu Qing was extremely embarrassed. It was considered an utter humiliation to counter the attack of one's opponent with the same spell. Charge. The vortex was casted. The thunderbolts were so fast that they would pierce through Yi Fushan's body in a second. Zhu Qing did not stop there. He started converging the fire element to initiate the following spell. As a double element mage, he was good at spell combos. However, Yi Fushan easily dodged the thunder vortex. He started charging toward Zhu Qing, carrying his own thunder vortex in his palm. This spell was supposed to be a ranged attack, but Yi Fushan transformed it into melee range. Yi Fushan almost teleported across the space between them, and he appeared right in front of Zhu Qing without leaving him any time to react. Zhu Qing's body was frozen. Yi Fushan was looking at Zhu Qing directly in the eye. His palm was so close to his body that Zhu Qing was just several centimeters away from death. He realized that Yi Fushan was showering him with mercy. Are we done? Yi Fushan dispelled his attack, then turned around and kept walking to Zhu Mu, leaving Zhu Qing behind him. Dumbfounded, he walked and talked in such a peaceful manner that people even somehow started to respect him. He defeated Zhu Qing, a powerful mage, with the exact same spell. How incredible was that? Was it true that musical sorcery was his weakest ability? As a disciple of the Ken Devil, was he still hiding more unknown power from everybody? Yi Fushan stopped in front of Zhu Mu. He laughed and challenged Zhu Mu. Yi Fushan, 3-star glory plane, please show me your ways. People knew he was doing this intentionally. They already knew his plane. He made this introduction only to agitate Zhu Mu. Zhu Mu ignored this provocation. The spirit and chi started converging in his body. He drew something in the air with his hand, and people noticed it was a sharp sword. The sword was made of gold element chi in the universe. Zhu Mu was serious. The audience was curious about how Yi Fushan would finally be defeated by a real genius. Zhu Mu suddenly launched his attack. The sword aimed right at Yi Fushan's throat, and it was flying really fast. Yi Fushan also made a quick reaction. He leaned to his left, and the sword missed him by such a narrow margin that it actually cut off several of his hairs. What? Yi Fushan sensed danger coming from behind. After missing the first strike, the sword turned around and flew back at him. However, meanwhile, another sword was approaching from the opposite direction. With a single stroke, swords were created endlessly. Controlling the swords with mental power, Yi Fushan was shocked at this ability. Invoker and musical sorcerer had the similar abilities in mental control. Yi Fushan summoned a terrifying gold element storm around his body to protect himself. The barrier was a dark gold, almost like a solid armor. When the swords connected with the barrier, rather than breaking through, they were absorbed by the armor. Since Zhu Mu was summoning hundreds of swords, each individual sword did not contain power strong enough to break through the barrier, but the quantity was just so immense. The swords Zhu Mu summoned were arranged into rows. Hundreds of swords hung all around the barrier Yi Fushan summoned, not attacking. Zhu Mu was obviously looking for a weak spot to concentrate his attack. Meanwhile, he kept summoning more and more swords into the fight. Yi Fushan believed he must act now to grab the upper hand. He suddenly came out of the barrier and appeared before Zhu Mu with wind element power. He realized that as the disciple of the Art Saint, Zhu Mu was a perfect invoker. However, He seemed to be really weak at martial arts. Melee ranged attack might provide a good opportunity for Yi Fushan. Countless swords suddenly started moving and chasing after him again. Several of them were deployed around Zhou Mu's body as defense mechanism. They were forming an array to intercept Yi Fushan. However, Yi Fushan slid through the defense and kept approaching Zhou Mu. Zhou Mu also knew melee range was his weak spot. He initiated a wind element spell to drive his body away from Yi Fushan. The array of swords moved with him. As Yi Fushan approached, the swords kept attacking him continuously. Zhou Mu was trying to block every possible route for Yi Fushan. Yi Fushan finally became impatient. He stopped dodging and form the golden armor around his body again. With the swords continuously crushing the armor, cracks started to show, and the armor finally shattered into pieces. However, a pair of wings appeared on his back. The golden wings covered his body from the swords, and he almost reached the melee range of Zhou Mu. Meanwhile, Zhou Mu had also finished his final summoning. He summoned a demon lion with wings on its back. In fact, people had never seen a demon lion like this. This monster was only made real because Zhou Mu was such a powerful invoker that he was able to inject his creation into form without being limited by reality. The demon lion pounced on Yi Fushan. People were shocked at how Zhou Mu kept summoning different forms of monsters by drawing. His incomparable mental power made it possible for a sorcerer to block a warrior outside his melee range. When the demon lion almost reached his body, Yi Fushan finally released his natal spirit, the divine rock. He decided not to hide this ability anymore because he had already released the rock in Donghai Academy, a mandate sorcerer. People were surprised and awed. The divine rock was made of wind and gold element powers. However, Yi Fushan was also a musical sorcerer. People were curious where that power of mental control came from. It obviously did not belong to the divine rock. A gold and gray storm consisting of both gold and wind elements converged around his body. Soon, he jumped into the air, and the speed he showed obviously came from the wind element spell. Yi Fushan became the incarnate of divine rock himself. The divine rock crashed with the demon lion in the air, and it generated a strong shock wave, knocking over many desks. While people opened their eyes again after the shock wave, they noticed that the demon lion failed. The momentum of divine rock tore the lion into pieces of spirit and chi, which soon disappeared in the space. The audience lost any previous estimation of how powerful Yi Fushan was supposed to be. He was a musical sorcerer, a multi-element, a mandate sorcerer, and a warrior. He even had such a powerful natal spirit. It seemed as if he had no weak spots at all. No wonder he said musical sorcery was his weak link. He had not been lying. Linza was astonished. She never imagined that the pretty boy she met would soon unveil his disguise and show how powerful he was. Nandu Wenshan felt a little bit frustrated. Now it was apparent that the disciple of the Qin Devil was more talented than the disciple of the Art Saint. The only reason Zhou Mu did not lose the fight in an embarrassing way was because he was still in the higher plane. "That's all you got. You are in the higher plane than I am." Yi Fushan laughed at Zhou Mu. Zhou Mu was seriously pissed off and decided to release his own natal spirit. The natal spirit was a shadow with the eyes of Satan. Evil mental power was permeating around Zhou Mu. Yi Fushan recognized this natal spirit. It was a mind-controlling natal spirit, and Yi Fushan believed there was quite a lot of similarities between this one and the eyes of storm he possessed. Yi Fushan was about to turn to the audience and announce that the fight was over. However, he suddenly perceived Zhou Mu's natal spirit, but it was too late. The mental power pierced into his mind and somehow started warning him. Chapter 59, I will be waiting for him here. Yi Fushan froze, conscious of the force of spiritual energy. Spiritual energy was an invisible force. If a powerful cultivator in the Arcana plane made a move with the energy, it was definitely possible for it to go unnoticed by others. "That's enough. Go home," a low voice resonated in his mind. It was hard to tell who the voice belonged to, but it did not seem to mean any harm. The voice only wanted to persuade him to stop here. In reality, Yi Fushan had already announced his leave after defeating Zhu King, but Zhou Mu stepped up, so he could only continue to fight. Hua Fengliu once lost to the Art Saint and even had his life spirit disabled. Then today, people insulted him, the art saint's disciple made the first move and went as far as destroying the Gin that Yi Fushan played. He could not just walk away after defeat. How would that reflect on Hua Fengliu? That was the reason for his attacks on Zhu Mu. Just as Yi Fushan was deep in thought, Zhu Mu had completed yet another drawing. This time, it was a large golden dragon, ferocious and arrogant. The golden dragon revolved around Zhu Mu's being. The energy from his life spirit rushed out in a crazed manner and descended on the dragon. It was as if a real dragon was present. Those that were shocked by Yi Fushan were now in awe because of Zhu Mu. He was even more intimidating since he was going all in. Yi Fushan showed no expression. A wild force of spiritual qi gathered in his body and formed a golden rock. He flew into the sky and shined brighter than anything else. At this point, Yi Fushan's only option was to fight until the end. However, he still appreciated the voice for warning him. Zhu Mu and Yi Fushan moved at the same time. The golden dragon and the golden rock were about to collide. The spiritual qi in the atmosphere went wild and the skies began to change color. High-level cultivators at the venue joined hands to create a force field to block out the powerful energy given off by Yi Fushan and Zhu Mu's attacks. Just then, Yi Fushan felt another force of spiritual energy invade his mind. This time, there were no warnings, but a direct attack. Yi Fushan felt a stabbing pain, then his nerves began to grow numb, almost like he was about to lose all his senses. Just as he was approaching Zhu Mu, Yi Fushan lost control of the flow of spiritual qi. Boom! A loud crash. Yi Fushan had no idea where the attack came from, but after he was attacked, his own attack on Zhu Mu was weakened by a significant amount. The golden dragon imploded. Zhu Mu and Yi Fushan retreated at the same time. All of these events happened in the span of minutes. When Yi Fushan landed on the ground, he felt no anger, but smiled instead. There were a lot of important people present at today's celebration. It was only natural that they could not put down their pride to intrude in a battle between two youngsters, but if they couldn't do it blatantly, they could do it in secret. Looks like the first voice that warned him knew that this would happen. Who was it that warned him? And who was it that attacked him? Obviously, Yi Fushan was not dumb enough to reveal that he had been attacked. His attacker was most likely looking for an excuse to put him in his place. If he were to come out and accuse of the high authority figures, then they would have a legitimate reason to get rid of Yi Fushan. Thank you for this experience. Yi Fushan smiled. However, he was not looking at Zhu Mu when he said this, but to the group of VIPs. His attacker would understand what he meant. I have unwillingly disturbed your celebration, Lord Luo. I am grateful for your understanding. If you'll excuse me, I shall be on my way now. Yi Fushan smiled as he bowed and turned to leave. He did not want to fight any longer. His attack had already resorted to this method. If Yi Fushan did not stop the battle, he would only be at a disadvantage. The battle isn't over. Are you really leaving? Zhu Mu shouted at Yi Fushan's back. He seemed to have gained quite a bit of confidence. Zhu Mu, that's enough, said the art saint. Zhu Mu was stunned, but when he recovered, he spoke again. If the opportunity ever comes again, we shall finish where we left off. At that time, I will be sure to give it my all. Sure, today is Lord Luo's celebration, so I didn't want to cause too much of a ruckus. Therefore, I only used about 50% of my power. When we battle again, you'll see what I'm talking about, said Yi Fushan as he continued on his way out of the palace. His words piqued Zhu Mu's interest. Yi Fushan was able to drive him to a breaking point, but now he said that he was only using half of his powers. Shameless maniac. Everyone began voicing their opinions of Yi Fushan. Somebody tried to brown nose the art saint once again. The art saint was nice enough to let him go without making him look bad after being defeated by Zhu Mu. How dare he say such ridiculous things? Absolutely preposterous. That shameless beast uttered. The insults continued around the venue. Zhu Mu's performance was fascinating. He is definitely fitting as your disciple, Brother Hua, complimented Lord Luo. Many people agreed with him, but the high-powered people present knew even though Zhu Mu was able to fend off Yi Fushan's attack towards the end, there was no telling how things would have ended had they continued their battle. Plus, Zhu Mu was two levels above Yi Fushan. His victory in this battle was nothing to brag about. Xia Fan did not look too good. He realized that he never got to truly get to know Yi Fushan. His extraordinary gifts would explain why Hua Fengliu was willing to take him in as a disciple and even went crazy to try to save him. Yi Fushan had to be rid of as soon as possible. He could not be allowed to keep growing stronger. At the party venue, besides the rivalry between the art saint and Yi Fushan's master, the Gun Devil, nobody had anything against Yi Fushan himself. Even if they had been humiliated by him today, it could not be considered a bloody feud. Therefore, they had no need to be wary of Yi Fushan. However, it was different for Xian. If he allowed Yi Fushan to keep getting stronger, Yi Fushan would definitely try to kill him. I never expected Yi Fushan to be able to withstand a battle with Zhu Mu. He is pretty gifted. No wonder the Gun Devil took him as a disciple. When I was in the city of Qingzhou, I even saw him flirting with Hua Jiu. The two of them seemed to have an extraordinary relationship. I'm afraid she has fallen victim to his lies. Yi Fushan harbors bad intentions, said Xia Fan. His words drew everyone's attention. It was obvious that Xia Fan had something against Yi Fushan. Hua Jiu is the little princess of the Nandu family, and from what everyone said, has an excellent gift. Brother Nandu, you should keep an eye out, said Lord Luo. Nandu Wenshan looked at Lord Luo and said, thank you for your advice. But Hua Jiu was in Qingzhou City cultivating under her father's guidance and Yi Fushan is his disciple. It's only natural that they will be in good relations with one another. However, I will still remember to have a talk with her. I'm sure that you will come to your own conclusions, nodded Lord Luo. Beside him, the art saint was in deep thought. After a while, he spoke up. Yi Fushan did not came to convey his blessings. If my predictions are correct, he came because Lord Luo could heal Hua Fengliu's injury. Lord Luo was stunned. You're saying that he originally wanted to come and ask me to heal his master? That's right, nodded the art saint. He thought back at home Yi Fushan stood up to the people who insulted Hua Fengliu and could not help but say, Hua Fengliu choose a good disciple. The art saint personally complimented Yi Fushan. Nobody knew what to say to that. Zhu Mu, head to Donghai Academy's School of the Emperor Star tomorrow, the art saint said suddenly. His voice was calm, as if he knew that just one word could get Zhu Mu into the school without testing. In addition, none of the high-powered authorities thought that this was strange. On the contrary, it seemed like such a normal thing. Even the elder from the Emperor Star School did not seem to have a problem with this. Yi Fushan would have never seen this coming. Okay, Zhu Mu nodded. Hua Jiu of the Nanu family was also in the Emperor Star School. Also, Yi Fushan attended Donghai Academy as well. A big congratulation to the School of the Emperor Star for gaining yet another spectacular student. Lord Luo smiled at the elder. Lin Zhu observed everything in silence. Yi Fushan's handsome figure appeared in her mind. That reckless fellow had no idea of the relationship between the Emperor Star School, the art saint, and Lord Luo. It was a good thing that he was clever. Although he was reckless, he was also careful. He did not do or say anything that could be used to threaten him in the future. Although a public setting such as this could not be considered dangerous, it seemed like Yi Fushan had already made some enemies. The celebration continued but could not return to the atmosphere at the beginning of the event. Lord Luo was supposed to be the only star of the night. However, his spotlight was stolen by Yi Fushan. At this moment, Yi Fushan was headed back to Donghai Academy mounted on the Black Wind Eagle. The wind blowing on him cleared his mind as well. He knew clearly that his actions today were reckless, but he could not bear to watch as the art saint received everyone's respect, and his disciple flooded with compliments, while Hua Fengliu was disabled and insulted to make the art saint look better. I'm afraid I've offended some people today, Yi Fushan muttered. He must be careful from now on, especially around Xia Fan. Yi Fushan knew that after the battle, Xia Fan was definitely going to try to kill him. As for the others, they may worry about their reputation and therefore not be able to take care of Yi Fushan personally, but that did not mean they wouldn't try to operate in the shadows. This point was evident when he was attacked during the battle against Zhu Mu. The person who attacked me is either the art saint or Lord Luo. Yi Fushan thought to himself, they were both sorcerers of the spirit element, and the person who gave me that warning was most likely the elder from the school of the Emperor Star, Yi Fushan analyzed. When Yi Fushan got back to Donghai Academy, many people stared at him. He was becoming more and more well-known around campus. However, Yi Fushan paid them no attention and continued on his way. It was then that several people came up and blocked his path. Yi Fushan, said the leader of the pack. Yes, Yi Fushan had never seen this person before. Jing Ying of the School of the Flirting Star wishes to challenge you. Why do you keep avoiding it? Asked the person. Yi Fushan looked at the person in front of him and thought of how stupid this was. He did not want to acknowledge them and so, he chose to escape from the side. When you said you didn't have time, it was just a poor excuse, wasn't it? You only got accepted into the School of the Finance Star because you defeated students from our school. Are you scared now that you got into the academy? Is this who you really are? Don't you think you're disgracing your school? The person continued to pester Yi Fushan. There were many onlookers at his point. Yi Fushan stopped in place, with his back still facing the students of the Flirting Star School. He said, I'm not in a good mood right now. So you better shut up and stop trying to pick a fight with me, or else you'll regret it. Finishing what he had to said, Yi Fushan was ready to walk away again, but the person would not take no for an answer. He laughed and said, you're really opening my eyes to something new. I've never met a person who can be so thick-skinned after being too chicken to battle. The foot that Yi Fushan picked up to leave was placed on the ground once again. Everyone watched as he turned around with a bright big smile and said, tell Jing Ying, I will be waiting for him here. Chapter 60, My Brother, My Shackle. The news that Yi Fushan finally accepted Jing Ying's challenge soon spread around all the academy, causing a great sensation. People were now swarming toward the dorm where Yi Fushan lived. Several weeks before, when Yi Fushan was first accepted to the School of Finance Star, Jing Ying issued him a letter formally challenging him, and Yi Fushan rejected it with the excuse that he did not have time, which made people confused. Jing Yang commented arrogantly on the response from Yi Fushan, saying he was just so-so. The whole story was rather dramatic. One of them was the genius who just got admitted, and the other one was the top student from the School of Flirting Star. This challenge was really important to students in the School of Flirting Star, because they hungered for the revenge. Yi Fushan's attitude truly made them upset. Now, Yi Fushan was agitated, and agreed to fight. There was already a large audience watching Yi Fushan. He stood peacefully, with his hands in his pockets. He acted almost like a master in this school. Tang Wan was looking at him, and believed he was using this manner as a bluff. Most students in the School of Flirting Star gradually arrived. They were all staring at Yi Fushan with hatred. They believed Jing Ying would definitely win this fight, because he was the private disciple of someone powerful who ran this school. There were also many students from the School of Finance Star. Some of them did not like Yi Fushan much, but still, they hoped that Yi Fushan would win. At least Yi Fushan was attending the same school, so this fight was obviously about dignity. Mu Yunqing and Mu Yunyi also came. They had been badly anticipating the fight, because there was finally someone able to get revenge for them. Since Jing Ying was not studying in the same place with others, he arrived a little bit late. When he arrived, he was surrounded by students from the School of Flirting Star. They were loud and imposing. The audience moved and formed a path for Jing Ying. The group with him also stopped, and let him enter the field where Yi Fushan was waiting. Finally, you agree to fight, coward? Jing Ying sneered at him. In fact, it was unexpected that Yi Fushan accepted the challenge. Stop spouting nonsense. You have wasted so much of my time, so just shut up and prepare to get your SS kicked. Yi Fushan looked at Jing Ying for the very first time. Jing Ying was confused about his attitude, and wondered how crazy this boy was to say something like that. The audience was also shocked. They could not understand this contempt from Yi Fushan at all. Jing Ying was the superstar in the School of Flirting Star, the private disciple of someone truly powerful who ran the school. However, Yi Fushan acted so arrogantly, as if it was a waste of his time to wait for Jing Ying. People soon remembered his no time for this comment about challenge, and became speechless about this boy. They realized he had never taken this fight seriously from the beginning. People from the School of Flirting Star looked extremely embarrassed. Never had there been a student who disrespected their school in such a way. Jing Ying sneered at Yi Fushan. "You are the first guy I..." Yi Fushan did not let him finish. He initiated his attack, shooting his body at Jing Ying like a thunder. Jing Ying swallowed the second half of his sentence. He started driving the spirit and chi in the universe to react. Silk imprisonment. Jing Ying cast his spell. The gold element power formed countless silk threads that flew towards Yi Fushan. They were blocking the space around him, confining his movement. "He is a genius, is he not?" People were in awe by Jing Ying. There are different levels of difficulty for spells, and silk imprisonment was definitely among the top level of all spells. It required extremely strong mental control to run thousands of silk threads at the same time. This spell was really mighty because it could confine the freedom of opponent, or directly kill him, depending on the will of the spell caster. A pair of golden wings made of spirit and chi appeared on Yi Fushan's back, and the wings were so sharp that they slashed the countless silk threads into pieces. The attack from Jing Ying was not effective at all facing the absolute power of Yi Fushan. Jing Ying was caught by surprise for a moment. He did not anticipate that Yi Fushan could survive his previous attack. He changed his spell a little, and suddenly, all the silk threads straightened and rained down as needles. Yi Fushan wrapped his wings around his body to protect himself from the needles, and charged at lightning speed at Jing Ying, leaving only his shadow behind. The next moment, Jing Ying saw a fist coming at him. Instead of fancy techniques, it was just a simple punch. Without any time for a reaction, Jing Ying's body fell to the ground, blood covering his face. He was the same plane as Yi Fushan, and the latter didn't want to waste his time. However, he was finally forced to accept because so many students in the academy started considering him a coward. He had to fight for his own reputation. This punch made the audience feel as if their hearts were shaking. It was truly nasty and rough. Soon, all they witnessed as Yi Fushan endlessly punched Jing Ying with his bare fists. Bang, bang, bang. With every sound of the solid punches, the audience was becoming more shocked by this fight. "Satisfied?" Yi Fushan said coldly. People were totally speechless. Yi Fushan asked Jing Ying if he was ready to get his ass kicked before the fight, and now he was restating his point. What an arrogant attitude. People were confused by how quickly and easily Jing Ying had been defeated. He was the private disciple of the School of the Flirting Stars supervisor, and had said that Yi Fushan was so-so before the fight. However, he had been totally humiliated by this fight. "Just so-so. That was Jing Ying, not Yi Fushan. Stop." Students from the School of Flirting Star felt angry, and yelled at Yi Fushan. Yi Fushan stood up and looked at those students. He laughed and said, "Is this what you were asking for?" He let go of Jing Ying and left. People even forgot to check on Jing Ying after he left. Yi Fushan could feel hundreds of eyes following him. This feeling of being the center of attention gave him a weird feeling of pride. "It's not my fault they asked for it." It seemed that as long as Yi Fushan was still a student of Donghai Academy, this humiliation of the School of Flirting Star would never be erased. Yi Fushan's mind was eased slightly after he let out his rage on Jing Ying. Staying in the Lord Palace was a good life for him, but somehow he felt depressed, especially now that it was impossible to find some help for Hua Fengliu. When he returned to the room, he noticed that there was one more person. Yu Sheng had lived with him for a long time. However, there was someone standing next to Yu Sheng in their room. Yi Fushan was surprised when he clearly saw the person. He kept blinking to make sure it was true. It was a girl, about 16 years old, standing next to Yu Sheng. She was petite and cute, with a gorgeous face. Yi Fushan confirmed with a quick glance that this girl was definitely a sweetheart. Yu Sheng and the girl noticed that Yi Fushan was back. The girl looked at Yi Fushan and started smiling. Yu Sheng opened his mouth, as if he was trying to explain. "Keep going, just ignore me." Yi Fushan turned around. "Wait," a soft voice said. Yi Fushan stopped, and saw the girl smiling at him. When she was smiling, the beauty from her unique youthfulness was even more attractive. "It's not what it looks like," Yu Sheng tried to explain. Yi Fushan laughed and asked, What does it look like? Yu Sheng was silent, not sure what to say. He had always been awkward compared to Yi Fushan. King Xuan came here for us, Yu Sheng said. Wow, you're using just her first name already. Sounds like there's been great progress between you guys, right? Yi Fushan was still making fun of him. Yu Sheng did not know how to respond at all. I told him to call me by my first name. The girl smiled and said, I'm Yi King Xuan, so just call me King Xuan. Yi Fushan, he also introduced himself. I know you. Yi King Xuan nodded. I was there watching your first fight with the School of Flirting Star. I saw every bit of the fight. You were so good. Yu Sheng is better. Yi Fushan was still laughing. It was almost like he was trying to make Yu Sheng more embarrassed. You are both really good. She kept smiling. He's not only good. You know what? He's single and available too. Yu Sheng wanted to run out the room. Yi King Xuan fluttered her beautiful lashes and smiled. You guys are interesting. I guess I will see you next time. She soon stood up and left. As she passed by Yi Fushan, he whispered to her, what do you think about my buddy? Like him? Yi King Xuan blushed and answered in lowered voice, he's nice. Then she just ran out of the room. Yi Fushan started to laugh even harder. He looked at Yu Sheng with a wicked smile and asked, tell me, Yu Sheng, how far did you go with her when I was not here? Yu Sheng said, she came to ask whether we would be willing to get tested and go to the upper level of cultivation in the School of Finance Star. She was sent here by the supervisor? Yi Fushan was curious. I guess so. I did not ask, Yu Sheng said. She must be someone special in this school. Not to mention, she is so beautiful and sweet. I think she's good for you. What do you think? Yi Fushan asked Yu Sheng. I have no idea what you are talking about. Yu Sheng was numb. Boy, she blushed when I asked her about you. I guess she's got a crush on you. Do you have the same feeling? Yi Fushan kept nagging him. My father told me to stay away from girls. You know that. He told me my lifelong task is to help you build your kingdom. Yu Sheng was serious. Yi Fushan had to stop joking when he realized Yu Sheng meant what he said. Then he started talking again. Yu Sheng, I know my godfather has really high expectations for me, but I believe the future is still far away for us. Life is so long that neither you nor I knows where we will end up. I know he believes I was born to be the king, but there is a long journey ahead of us. So, I hope we can enjoy this journey together. We are brothers, not master and servant. The future belongs to both of us. It's his will that I should live for you. It's meant to be this way, Yu Sheng insisted. I told you, he's not here, so forget about what he said. My word is the law now. Yi Fushan had suddenly started to yell. Yu Sheng was shocked seeing him angry. He lowered his head, but still looked stubborn. The guilty look on Yu Sheng's face made Yi Fushan somewhat regret yelling at him. He lowered his voice and said, Yu Sheng, forget the shackles he has put on you. You should have your own life, a really happy one. If you do, I will also feel happy for you even you leave me alone someday. Yu Sheng looked at Yi Fushan, and found that he was smiling again. He almost cried, and swore to himself that he would never leave Yi Fushan alone, ever.